Today's podcast is brought to you by Audible.com. Get a free audiobook download and 30-day free trial at www.audibletrial.com/TWIK. Transform your commute, workout, or chores with over 180,000 titles to choose from for your smartphone or tablet. Welcome, my Jingos, to episode 73 of This Week in K-Pop. In this episode, we will talk about 9MUSES, AOA, Big Bang, BtoB, BTS, Playback, Sistar, Teen Top, and more. My name is Steven, and with me is my co-host Josh.
Hello.
I'm so tired, man. There's so much to say.
I know.
As you can see, we're joined, of course, by someone. Who are you again?
Hey guys, it's Mina. I'm back.
And why would you be back for this episode?
Yeah, I wonder why.
I don't know.
Huh, it's because of AOA, right?
Yeah, she loves AOA.
She loves that. It's because of Sistar.
Yeah, she loves the Sistar.
That playback, right?
She loves the playback.
Of course. It can't be.
It's got to be the verbal Jint.
Oh, the verbal Jint.
Bubble Jint.
The Phantoms.
The Sanchez.
Sanchez.
The dirty Sanchez.
But anyways, we brought Mina back, of course, because BTS had a release. And, of course, you know. This was a big 2 weeks in K-pop, so we wanted.
Big.
Yeah, could have been bigger. Could have been bigger if Girls' Generation came out or Girls' Day came out, but
yeah,
it didn't come out.
That's very true.
But it was a huge. I mean, so we just wanted another voice.
Another voice, yeah. And you guys have been asking for her to come back, bring her back, and here she is. We're gonna try to bring her back as much as possible. At least for the releases that we feel we need to have a different perspective on, like BTS or Big Bang. So hope you enjoy this podcast.
I think this one's going to be, there's going to be some fighting.
A little bit.
I think there's going to be some arguments.
Yeah, we had a little bit of arguments when we were picking our list.
Yeah.
We narrowed it down to 12 songs between the three of us. So,
yeah. But if this is your first episode, This Week in K-Pop is a discussion podcast that covers the last 2 weeks of K-Pop music video releases. And each week, Josh and I, and now Mina, will choose what we thought was the best song of the last 2 weeks.
Yeah.
And we're going to start with Josh.
Of course, with me all the time. It's kind of strange because a lot of the songs that I feel we picked as our best songs of the week.
Mm-hmm.
They came out not last week, but pretty much the week.
Pretty much right after we finished the last episode.
A lot of the big releases kind of came out that week, like a few days later. So we had some time to listen to these. Some songs stuck around, some songs didn't. But my favorite song of the last 2 weeks, it was really close, but it's Sistar with Shake It.
Now,
Sistar is back for another summer release. Sistar, I guess, go hand in hand with summer releases.
They do.
And this song sounds super summery, super fun. The reason why I chose it was it sounds very Sistar-y, and it kind of reminded me why I really liked Sistar in the first place. They're fun. They're really, really attractive women. And they got bodies and legs for days.
Damn.
Yeah, even Mina would be like, damn. So the song, I do have to say, doesn't have a very distinct chorus. The chorus is just kind of like a whole bunch of na-na-nas and a lot of haze, which is not bad. I really like songs that have like do-do-do's or na-na-na's or those kind of sounds like haze or clapping. I really like those songs because I feel like those elements kind of make a song more catchy. Even though the chorus doesn't really have words in it, I thought it was really catchy. But this is kind of like a, kind of like, I call it a firework song. It kind of shoots up, explodes, and it's great, and it doesn't really have any more lasting value. Just because it's so catchy in the beginning, but it doesn't really have any more depth as like a song, you know? What did you think about it, Steven?
When I first heard the song, and I still kind of feel this way, it feels to me like they took a minute of filler in another song, and then extended that minute of filler into a 3-minute song.
Fair enough.
There's parts in the song that are, you know, I really like a lot of this song. I think it's oddly catchy in a kind of like a way where you don't really notice until 4 days later, and you're just like, nah, 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 and you're like, where did that come from?
Yeah.
So, like, I think this song really benefited from being released really early in this kind of episode cycle, because I had a lot of time to listen to it. But, you know, the best summer song, I mean, we all know what the best Sistar summer song is, right, Mina?
I guess.
What song is that?
What is it?
The best Sistar summer song of all time.
Not even Sistar song.
Is it? Which one is it?
She don't know.
You're failing me.
She don't know.
That,
I guess that's
loving
why we bring her.
There it is. Loving you.
There it is.
I mean, the reason why I like Loving You is because, like, all parts of that song, like the verse, the chorus, like every part is catchy to me. And the fact that this song doesn't really have a verse, like, it just sounds like a lot of filter and a lot of, like, waste of, like, it's like when you're kind of like, like, maybe at the end of a television show, and they're, like, they just want, everyone's just kind of, like, kind of moving around, like, not doing, like, I don't know why I get that sense from this song, but I just kind of get that.
Yeah.
Like, it just doesn't sound like a complete song, I guess, is what I'm trying to say.
I think I know what you're getting at. Like, I wouldn't go as far to use, like, that harsher words, but it does sound like a song that doesn't really have, like, a build-up or distinct parts. It kind of just, like, starts really, like, high and just keeps at this high level until the end of the song. It doesn't really have any like kind of lows or like build up or kind of like breakdowns, because like Loving You had that one part where it's kind of had that breakdown into like electric guitar, you know what I'm talking about?
Yeah like Loving You, I don't, sounds kind of weird, but like I think that's like a song, right? Like like Hyorin sings in this, but I don't think it's very substantial.
Yeah, it's just upbeat all the time, 100%, right?
Yes. I don't know. I just think there's a lot of filler in it. Like, I think there's a lot of wasted time, which I think they cover up decently well, you know, with the, you know, na-na-na-na-na-nas and the shake-its, you know? Mm-hmm. Like, I don't think it's bad. Like, I think it's a song that I'm going to enjoy for a long time. Like, I don't want to make it die. I don't like it. Like, I like this song. Like, if I didn't pick my song, this would probably be second.
Yeah, so this is, so for the record, even though Steven is saying these things, this is like his second favorite song of the week.
I'm saying the reason it's not the first pick is because I feel that it's
missing something.
It's missing something.
Fair enough.
But what did you think, Mina?
I remember like when I first heard it, I didn't like it. I remember because then I messaged you. I was like, this isn't. And then I was like so confused because I was like, where's the chorus? Like, I was like, is there even a chorus? But it definitely grew on me. I was, where was I going? I went somewhere and then the song would
to drink
on.
Probably to drink.
You might have went to drink.
If all y'all chingus thought I drink a lot, you don't know Mina. So we were all actually here together yesterday. We had dinner together and we were all just sitting around and Mina was like, okay, it's time to go out. And I was like, what time is it? It's like 1:00. And I was like, yeah, I'm not going to go out because I'm going to stay out really late, get really, really drunk. And Mina's like, all right, then, peace. And she goes out. She gets smashed. We have to call her at like 8:00 today to come record. And she texts back, okay, I'll put my face on. Order me some McDonald's. I'll be right there. And that goes to show you why me and Steven always are ragging on Mina for being the drinker she is. So you were on your way to drink.
Anyways,
I didn't want to
on your way.
You were on your way to drink. And then...
and this song came on.
Soju bottle one hand, beer another.
You're like, na-na-na-na-na-na-na. Hey!
Okay, I guess.
It's because there's two of us. There's only one of her here. Yeah. She can't defend herself.
So you were going somewhere. You heard the song.
Yeah, I heard the song. And I was like, I was like, oh my God. Hey, I really like it, you know, and then, like, I took a second listen, because then I only listened to it once, and so, I don't have a lot of girl group songs in my phone, but I would definitely download it. I haven't downloaded it yet, but I would, and I would put it in my phone. And if I put it in my phone, that means that it's
top tier.
Yeah, for me.
Well, I mean, I think expectations, like, I didn't really like it at first either, because, like, I was expecting a song, and I still don't feel like this was a full song, right? Like, but it turns out that all the parts in it are pretty damn catchy. And they're, the best part about this is that it's easy to emulate, right? Yeah. Like, we can sing the na-na-na-nas and the shake-it-shake-its.
Yeah.
And, it's so easy to chant with, and that's what makes, I think, a really good summer song.
Yeah, because, like, for me, long-time listeners will know that I kind of will put a little bit of bias to songs that I can sing along to, because I think that's a huge part of, like, K-pop's catchiness, is, like, you can emulate the dances or emulate, like, the singing of it. So I feel like a lot of people can emulate the song and definitely the dance, because the dance is really, really simple. But I do have some qualms with the dance, because it seems like just a patchwork of a lot of moves that I've seen before. Everybody kind of copies each other's moves. Like these days we have just a super trend of people just doing the nae-nae like all the time. And I'm pretty sure people are going to start whipping and nae-naing like very, very soon together. And there was some nae-naing in this song. There was some Girls' Day Darling in this song.
There were some older Sistar songs in this song. Yeah,
some older Sistar dance
moves. Like, I feel like I've seen this move before in a Sistar song.
Yeah, yeah. So I feel like we've come to a point in K-pop that moves are not really unique anymore. It's really, really hard to find a move that you have not seen before. So... yeah.
Well, I wanted to say, like, we talked a lot about the song, so we should talk about the music video. And of course the dance kind of goes with it, but what did you think, Mina, about the overall music video?
Okay, so this is I was talking about this before, but I wouldn't play this song for my students to watch. It's just, it's so like...
And you teach it in a middle school.
Yeah, and I teach it in a middle school, and it's all girls.
Utilizing.
Yeah, so I would feel really uncomfortable just playing the song for them.
But would you have played, say, like, Girls' Day, or would you have played, like, an older AOA song for them? And have no problem? Like, what's different?
Even,
like, what?
Even then, still.
It still would have been.
Yeah, I wouldn't. Because I always watch the music videos before I
like
even...
I do that, approve too.
Of playing it at my school. Just because I don't want...
You just
want
to be safe.
Yeah.
Yeah, you just want to be on the safer end, right?
Yeah. But...
Is there, like, a specific part that you
that
thought was,
you
like, really inappropriate?
Especially all the butt shots. And when the girls are in the tights and, like...
Yoga
like
the yoga pants.
I mean, like, oh my God, I love their bodies. Like, they're hot, you know? But it's just... I don't know, like... I mean, but being sexy is Sistar.
Yeah,
I totally know that. Yeah. So, like, seeing this, it doesn't surprise me. But if it was, like, for example, like, Secret was, like, doing this or something, I'd be like, oh, my God, no, Secret, please don't.
Like, no, I agree. I think this was much more blatant, right? Like, when you think of Sistar alone, like, that was sexy as fuck, but it was sexy in a very, like...
kind of refined
way. Like, all they really did was they just lifted their leg and they lifted it down, right?
Yeah.
It wasn't, like... you know, it wasn't them shaking their ass. It wasn't look at my titties, right? So, like, they were really good at that. And I think this one was very, like...
in
your face.
Yeah, I don't want to say cliche, but a lot of girl groups, like, kind of get really famous. I'm not talking about Sistar, but a lot of girl groups will get famous just from, like, sneaking those shots in of just, like, boobs or butt. Like Secret's, like Hyozung, she gets away with a lot of that.
Yeah.
And I think her popularity is just rising and rising because of that. But
I mean, it's not new. Like, I think some people kind of got mad at Sistar for the last their last song.
Which one?
The one with the butt. Not the one before. I swear.
Touch my body.
Like, I remember when Touch My Body came out, and people were like. Like, they were just so, like, they're wearing swimsuits and, like, so, I mean, even the dance is literally, like a butt, but pow,
shake it,
what
shake
pow,
it,
you know?
Shake it a butt, Shake it down.
So, you know, and this song also has kind of a lot of downvotes for a Sistar song,
just
for any
that.
K-pop song, really.
Yeah.
And so I think some people are kind of, angry, I guess, at the direction that Sistar is taking, and I just was wondering if, like, do you feel the same way? Like, I don't think I would downvote it. Like, I don't think it was that bad.
Yeah.
Because it's kind of like the direction K-pop is going in general, and not just for girl groups, for guy groups as well. It's just getting more and more sexual, and well, I think me and you talked about this, Steven, a while back. Like, yeah, you can be sexy and sensual and all that, but there's, you have to realize that a lot of, like, kids watch this as well. Like, even I think this rating was only 15, and my boys, like, are 15. I would not show this to them. They would just, like, their pants would explode.
Well, the thing is, I think the weird thing though is that the yoga pants thing, when we all see those yoga pants, we're like, oh my god, that's fucking crazy. But in Korea, we know most girls who wear yoga pants wear a skirt over, right? Yeah. So
it's
like,
built in.
It's weird to me that, like, we've seen things get 19 plus, right?
Mm-hmm.
And, like, to me, in my head, like, straight up yoga pants where you can see, like, every outline of that, like, that's pretty, you know, nasty.
Yeah.
But, you know, this is a 15, right? This is, like, not even considered that bad. And maybe it's just, like, they don't have that understanding of, like, how awesome yoga pants are, I guess, in Korea yet. I don't know.
Yeah.
But, like, I didn't think it was that sexy, or not, like, overly sexy. I really didn't think, except for the outfit that they chose.
Yeah.
Like, I think overall the dance is actually not that.
It's quite tame comparatively to other dance moves we've seen.
Like, it's no, like, you brought up Girls' Day, Female President or something like that.
Female President, yeah.
Where it's literally hands on your head,
and just
butt shaking, right?
It.
Like, this was no. I did want to mention that, I really did like the song and the dance because, as you said, you know, I don't speak Korean, right? And the reason I like Wonder Girls, I've always liked Wonder Girls because their choruses were always in English, and I can sing to it too, right? And so this, a lot of the na-na-na-nas and the shake-it's like, it's in English, and I like that. But also the dance is like, aside from the fact that they're wearing heels, and that's, it's crazy that they can do that.
But, I mean, Sistar is known for dancing in heels, right?
Right. But, like, you know, I watched the dance video, and it's, like, it's actually a really simple dance that a lot of people can do.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah.
I can totally see a bunch of my middle school students dancing this, at the end of
the year. I don't want to see it, but they might do it.
I mean, you want to see them do this or AOA? Because they do a lot. They've done every AOA song.
Really?
So, yeah.
Oh, God.
Yeah. Actually, they did a lot of short hair, and short hair is not that bad.
Short hair is not that bad.
Not
as bad as the other ones.
Yeah.
Like, Confused was, I think, pretty bad. They were, like, writhing around on the couch.
Yeah, there was some couchiness.
Yeah, definitely, Short Skirt was definitely...
Shorts was, like, the brightest one. But they also did Like a Cat, so...
Yeah.
Anyways, we'll talk about AOA later. Let's move on, I guess, to the next song, which is by BtoB. With their song, It's Okay.
괜찮아요.
Yeah, so BtoB, Mina, why don't you start with, did you like It's Okay or not?
I really like the meaning behind it because it's kind of like a cheer up kind of song. Like,
yeah.
I know you're having a hard time. And so, like, listen to this song. It's like, we want to give you some strength from the song. I really liked it. I liked how their voices, like, all fit into together because I don't really listen to BtoB. So, like, for me to say that I like this song would be like, people who know me, like, they're like, oh my gosh, do you like BtoB?
Because BtoB is, like, not your style of boy group, right?
Yeah, they're not, so.
But this song is also not their normal style. Their
normal style
is, like, super fun,
it's
super,
like,
quirky.
Quirky.
I mean, we say that as we're not, like, historians of BtoB, right? Like,
no.
For all we know,
maybe. They're major releases. Their major releases are all very fun and poppy.
Yeah.
You like this song too, right?
Yeah, I really like this song, just mainly because I really like the harmonization that they pulled. because I've known for a long while that BtoB, they can sing pretty well, and this is a really good song that kind of showcases their singing versus kind of like a pop, more pop song. You don't really get to show off your chops as much, but they had kind of parts in the song where one person would be singing like a high note and like other people would be singing like, you know, like that kind of layering. Yeah, they layered it very well to a point where it doesn't sound noisy, but it sounds very full. That's why I really like the song. Other if it didn't really have that, it would sound like any other ballad or OST, to be honest. And that just kind of will just be paired with whatever kind of imagery you see, because ballads usually, or OSTs are usually that, right? Like, you don't like the OST for the OST, you like it because it's in a drama, that you remember that one scene where so-and-so confessed to so-and-so, and that song was playing in the background, and you forever imprint that feeling and image with that song, right? And BtoB, they kind of have a little bit of that, but I feel like it was really, really strong in the sense of vocal layering, and just producing was really, really done well. What about you, Steve? What do you think?
I mean, I don't like it as much as you guys, just because this is not my...
Steven's not a ballad thing.
I'm not a guy. I thought it was okay. I wasn't like, let's turn this shit off right now, you know?
Which we do with some songs.
Which we do with a lot of ballads. You know, not just me. I mean, like, Josh does it all the time. It's just like 10 seconds in.
We're done with this.
I mean... But again, for me, like when I hear B2B, like I kind of want to hear the fun B2B, right? I want to hear the quirky, kind of weird B2B. Like, I didn't think that this ballad was special. I think it was, I guess, produced really well, and I guess arranged really decently well. But it's you know, it's not a song that I would download and I'm going to listen to. Would you download? I don't even know if you would.
Yeah, so me and Steven kind of have like this, a rating, I guess you would say.
Will we download it?
Will we download it, and will it, and how long it will stay in our playlist, kind of deal. This song, I'll definitely download it, but I'm not too sure how long it would stay in my playlist, just because ballads on my playlist, they don't really last very long. So that just kind of goes to show what I kind of listen to. But this song is the definite download song, so.
Yeah, I don't really download ballads. How about you?
I already downloaded it. It's on my phone.
Wow. So surprising. Mina thinks quite highly of this.
Do you normally listen to ballads like this? Or is it, you know, like a moody thing now? You know, like what?
I guess it's a little bit of both. Recently, I've been like really balladly.
Kind of in a ballad mood?
Yeah. But I like ballads.
Yeah, I feel like out of the three of us, you like ballads the most.
Yeah.
I'm obviously second, and Steven is the last.
If it's a ballad with the beat, though.
Ballad with the beat, though.
I'm on top of that.
But yeah, this song doesn't have a dance, which is okay for a ballad, right? You can't really expect a dance. But what do you guys think about the music video?
I mean, I thought it was okay. Like, I think it's shot decent, but it's just the most, it's just generic music video. It's like... Oh man, these guys are having troubles, but they all worked out, you know.
All worked out in the end.
Which is fine, right? That's the point of the song, right? Yeah. You know, like that kind of makes sense. I mean, some of the stories don't really make any sense to me.
Yeah, there's one story that really doesn't make sense. So there's let's try to break it down. So there's one guy who's a musician major. And he's going on some trek. And then there's another guy who's a fireman, who's like a new fireman or something, because he's doing all the bitch work. Yeah. And he gets called up to like some accident. And one guy's a radio DJ. And another guy.
Which one's the one that you're saying doesn't...
There's an artist. He's like an art student. And he's just like drawing. And the teacher pulls him aside. And she's like, no, this won't do. And he has to like hand out some flyers for his part-time job or something.
To pay for tuition?
I don't know, but some guy was like, hey, you put that on my car, like, take it off. And he just, like, flips and is about to punch the guy. I'm like, okay, where did that come from? Like, all right, that's the least believable out of all the stories.
Oh, I thought what she said was, like, oh, you need to, like, pay up for tuition, like...
Yeah, but still, like...
And then he's, like, doing, like, part-time jobs to, like...
Like, he doesn't want to be hanged in
out. Yeah, he's like, I want to be drawing. And then he's, like, oh... And then he's just, like, that guy was just, like... Like, being, like, disrespectful. Just because, like, he's, like, that's his job. And he has to do it. And he's, like, come over here, get this off my car. And then he's just, like...
Yeah, but I mean...
He's just, like...
I
just imagine maybe he's like super duper stressed, and like if somebody does something to you, like it pisses you off and you're just like, like what the fuck.
But I feel like that was the least believable out of all the stories, right? Like,
I mean, I thought you were gonna say the walking dude.
The walking dude is also pretty fucking confusing.
Walking dude don't make no goddamn sense.
Like, so the walking dude, I think it's Sungjae. Yeah, Sungjae.
He's like, he needs to finish a composition. Yeah. But it's weird because at first he's shown eating like $1 million worth of food.
Yeah.
Why? I don't know. Because
he's going to leave.
But then he starts walking and then he's like, oh shit, I didn't pack any food and I didn't pack any water.
And I'm like dying of heat stroke.
I'm dying of heat stroke. And then the next thing you see, he's like, hey, I'm better now. Like,
hey, it rained on me.
Yeah, it rained on me.
Water in my mouth.
Life is great now. It's like, all right. Well, that's cool.
Yeah.
Also, didn't think the boyfriend who wanted to break up with the girlfriend. The girlfriend's like, "No, I won't let you break up with me."
No, because what happened was it was like the guy was like, "Okay, let's meet like at a tteokbokki restaurant, right? Because it's like cheap, and he doesn't have much money. He's wearing like track suit,
sure.
And she's like, "No, let's not go here. Let's go to a nice place." And she takes him to his place, and he looks at the menu and has like a whole bunch of.
Yeah, expensive things.
And he pulls out the money in his pocket and he doesn't have enough. And in the end,
$6.
Yeah, and the girl was like, oh, since you're not saying anything, that means you have to eat more, so I'm going to buy...
A bunch of stuff.
Yeah, I'm going to buy a bunch of stuff. And
girl,
he feels,
you
and
ain't
he,
a good girlfriend.
And like, he feels all like...
Yeah, obligated. He's bad, right? He's like, I want to pay for you, but I can't pay for you. I got no money.
Yeah, and then...
It's his man pride.
Yeah, and then he was like... Hey, let's break up because it's too hard. And she's like, no, you're having a hard time studying. That's what it is.
Yeah, and then what's the moral of the story? He gets money and they're happy together?
Yeah, that's the moral of the story. Korea, bro.
That doesn't make
Korea.
Any sense.
Korea.
Korea. Well, anyways, I mean, BtoB, it was okay. At least for me. You guys really liked the song.
Yeah, it was one of my favorite songs of this week. I wouldn't say it's top... three, maybe top four, which is saying how good the songs are this week, I feel.
Hmm.
Yeah, because like all 9 of these songs I would download and put in my playlist for sure.
Wait. The firefighter guy.
Yeah, what about him?
When he was at the accident, and he, there was a keychain.
Oh, locket? Like a picture?
Yeah. What was it?
Oh.
Like, I don't know. That was what I was going to mention earlier.
Maybe he was sad. Maybe he was sad he couldn't save the girl.
But then, well, who was that girl that came by at the fire station afterwards?
Yeah, that was a girl to, like, thank her.
His future wife? I don't know.
No.
Yeah, honestly, I think we spent way too much time talking about a youth, like, something that, you know, some writer banged out in, like, 20 minutes.
Yeah, like this is very generic. Like, oh, we're hard on our luck, and then now we're okay.
We're okay now.
Yeah, I mean it's well shot, but it is very cliche.
Mm-hmm.
So,
but at least they all weren't chasing after one girl, right?
So yeah,
they got that.
That's very true.
All right, Mina, can you introduce?
Okay, our next song is by Teen Top.
Why'd you say it that way?
Well, I don't know, because for me, like, I would really say
Well, the English is but the Korean is 아침부터 아침까지, which means from the morning until the morning.
Next morning.
Yeah, so it's just kind of like...
Oh, yeah, that makes perfect sense, guys.
Yeah, the English, though. What?
Yeah. It could have, like...
It's okay. There's a worse name
there.
So anyways, we add to that.
Okay, so I'll talk about this.
Sure.
Go first.
I really don't like the song.
Whoa! Yeah. Throw in the gauntlets.
Throw in shade. Throw in shade.
They're going to kick the shit out of you.
What are their teen tops fan groups called? Triceratops? I don't know what they're called.
No. They're called Angels.
Angels? No. Teen Toppies? Teeny Weeny
Toppers? They're the TDs? TTs?
Teeny Weeny Toppers? You should know this, Vita. This is why we bring you on.
I don't know what they're thinking. I'm sorry. It doesn't matter.
I want to say it's Angels.
Okay.
Do you have Teen Top songs that you normally like? Like, do you have expectations for Teen Top or what? Like, what's your relationship with Teen Top?
I mean, there's what's that one song? It was like one of their older songs that I really like. Kinzeng
Morikunyo. Kinzeng Morikunyo.
Or that one too. But there's another one. It was the one where their heart was their.
Penis?
Pointing at your penis, man. Their heart was their penis?
Yeah.
That doesn't help me, Mina.
Then in the dance, they're like, don't hurt my heart. And then they're like,
and it touching their penis?
Yeah.
To be fair, I mean, I only ask because I don't think either one of us... Like, Josh is probably most familiar with Teen Top. I don't know donkey shit about
Teen Top. I do like Teen Top, but I don't follow Teen Top.
Yeah, okay. Same.
Like, the thing...
My niece really likes them.
Whenever I hear Teen Top, I think of... That the one where they're all the one music video that we're all in prison and they all have nicknames and one dude's Scatty 66 or something like that. And I remember that for the rest of my life.
That was a long haired woman.
Oh, was that long haired woman? Yeah. I don't know. I just it's Scatty 66.
Scatty 69.
Scatty. It may have been 69, but I don't think it was 69. But anyways, why did you not like this song? We should.
I guess it's just the song just wasn't like. It's either hit or miss with me. Mm. Like, if I first listen to it, and then second time, and third time, I'm still, like, kind of iffy about it. Like, I don't really like it.
So how many times have you heard this song?
Well, the first time I watched it when it came out, and then I watched it a second time because my students asked me to, mm-hmm. and then...
Oh, you watched it a third time? Yeah,
here.
So you've watched it you've given it like three chances.
Yeah.
To like, I don't know.
Yeah.
Okay.
I mean, I gave it one chance and I agree with you, so. I didn't feel that there's anything that stands out with this song. I mean, Teen Top always kind of has like, you know, decent legwork kind of choreography, but I thought it was like just too flaily in this one. It was like too flaily, and like when it's too flaily it doesn't look clean, and I don't like it when it doesn't look clean. So I just I don't know, there's some crotch grabbing, but like I don't know, I didn't think it was a particularly noteworthy song, really.
So you guys might realize who put this song on here. Well, it was your good old friend Josh. The reason why I like this song so much is because, one, I do like Teen Top's kind of style. It is very kind of like contemporary pop-ish. And I really, really, really like that Teen Top has like really, really good footwork. I do agree with you, Steven. I do this a little bit too... like much in this video. They're trying to do too much, but it is still like quite good, and the song I feel is catchy enough for me to want to listen to it a few more times. I've only heard it twice, and the second time I heard it I was like, yeah, I do like this song. So for me, this is a song that I want to listen to a few more times at least to decide whether or not I, you know, want to put it on my playlist or not. But as of now, I'm planning to put it on my playlist. I guess I'm the only...
I mean, maybe if the song came out in a different episode, you know, like...
Comparatively.
Comparative to me, it's like, well, there's five other songs that I would rather listen to than this song. Mm-hmm. So, like,
fair enough.
I'm just not going to...
Yeah, this song would not crack my top five, but I wanted to talk about this song because I feel like it is a good song when you don't compare it to other songs.
I feel like I've heard better Teen Top songs.
But but you said you're not a fan of Teen Top.
But I don't know any of their names. But like I think even their last release, there was one release, remember, they were like all dancing in a, it's like black and white, and they're all dancing in a warehouse, and I really like that song. the song that you were singing earlier, that teen song
doesn't really describe.
I mean, I don't. That's the thing. I don't.
Steven just said, you know, the black and white boy group where they're dancing in a warehouse. That's like everyone.
I mean, the actual thing was in black and white. Not their outfits were black and white.
Like, the video. You know that girl group where they do the sexy dance and they're like. Acting this all was cute like, and stuff. You know what I'm talking about?
If you saw this video, my description...
Shit, what is that?
Defines it exactly.
Shit, you know the bright color girl group?
You know what?
You know? They're acting sexy? You know?
I don't need this from you. Because someone instantly understands which song I'm talking about.
Yeah, a Teen Top fan.
Yeah, because it was all in black and white. Like,
raise your hand if you're a Teen Top fan here.
How about raise your hand if you can name a black and white video right now?
A black and white video?
That's what I said. The video is in black and white. I very specifically said it's not the outfits that are black and white. The video is in black and white.
4 minutes
crazy. 4 minutes crazy.
Are they a boy group?
Okay, a boy group.
Okay. Well, I'm saying you're trying to make fun of me. Like, I said something super vague, but I actually said something very specific.
No, the black and white part, I'll give it to you, but...
Whatever. I don't need y'all.
I don't think we know Teen Top well enough.
I don't need y'all. Yeah. All I care about is that somebody out there hopefully understood.
Yeah, if you know what Steven is, Steven needs allies. Look, please leave a comment.
I can just scroll through this YouTube, and I'm sure it'll be like number six, but I don't want to scroll through right now. Because you hurt my feelings.
I'm sorry, Steven.
You hurt my feelings. By the way, I was watching y'all play that game, and there were many clues where it was like the generic upon the most vague true. So you know what?
Very true.
I spit on myself. I was so angry, I spit on myself.
Calm down.
All right, well, let's calm it down. Let's talk about something that I like, right? Let's talk about something that's good.
All
right. Every so often, right, there's a K-drama that just needs to be seen.
Fair enough.
And the drama producer has a superstar cast, including You Who Came From the Stars, Kim Soo-hyun, IU, My Sassy Girls, Cha Tae-hyun, and It's Okay That's Love's Kong Hyo-jin. It's part K-drama, part mockumentary, and the first of its kind for Korean television. If you haven't seen it yet, all 12 episodes are now on dramafever.com, and you can marathon the entire series right now by going to dfvr.co/twikproducer. And if you're a drama fan and you like what you see, please also consider subscribing to Drama Fever Premium for as low as 99 cents per month. For the cost of two meals, you get a year's worth of access to all your favorite dramas and movies in HD with little to no ads. Drama Fever is the best and easiest way to stream all your favorite Asian dramas and movies. Please use our special link, dfvr.co/twikproducer. You can find it in the show notes. You can find it in our YouTube description. By clicking it, you are directly supporting us and Drama Fever too.
Yeah. If you plan to subscribe to Drama Fever in general, please use that link. It will help us a great deal.
Yeah, if you're just like interested, you're like, I want to check out a Korean drama, just use that link, check out producer, just watch episode one at least. Hopefully you'll like it so much that you're going to want to watch all of it in HD. But you should really give it a chance. I mean, I've seen, you know, about half of it.
Mm-hmm.
And it takes some getting used to because it is very different. It is the first Korean drama to be like kind of a mockumentary. It's not a mockumentary like The Office is. It's more like a Korean variety show mockumentary, not American show mockumentary. IU is so pretty.
She's so pretty.
Like, I always thought IU was like really cute, but like...
She's becoming prettier and prettier.
It's so pretty. All right. Sorry.
You're just a roller coaster of emotions. It's like angry, just so pretty. Betrayed, and then just dumbfounded.
And Kim Soo-hyun is... Actually, he kind of has like a goofy-ass haircut. He kind of has like a same haircut he had in like Dream High, where they kind of make him like the bumbly, like idiot kind. So it's not really like You Who Came From the Stars, you know, yeah. Kim Soo-hyun. But, I mean, he's still a sexy dude. Kim Jong-guk is in there from Running Man.
Really?
They have a lot of cameos, yeah.
Yeah. Uh-huh. It's weird to see him in it. because he's just like too buff to be like,
you're too buff to do anything.
It's like, you're not a producer on a TV show. Like, that doesn't make sense.
You're Mr. Korea 2015.
Yeah. But, you know, if you like Running Man, you like Kim Jungkook, you should check out Producer. But let's move on to Mina's favorite song of the episode. Mm-hmm. You might be able to guess what it is.
I wonder what that is.
I don't know. What is?
Okay, so my favorite song of the week is Bangtanseoyuna BTS's Dope.
Dope, yo.
Or Sick.
So dope.
So sick.
So sick.
So jodo.
My chingus.
Jodo is like slang for that dope, sick, tight, whatever the young kids are saying nowadays.
That's so cool. Wait, no, that's
not. Is that so cool? is that what the kids are saying? That's so cool.
I think she's out of touch.
I think
she's out of touch with the youngins.
But so we know BTS is your favorite, but what especially?
Why do you like this song?
Yeah, why do you like this song so much?
Visually, I really like.
Okay, the song first.
Really like the, like, it's really simple, like, especially that joro part, it's like, joro, joro, and it's just, like, it's really catchy, and, like, I, like, when I first listened to it, it was, like, I knew I was able to, like, go along with it. I really like the vocals of Jungkook, he's the first singer, Jungkook and Jimin, the one with the red hair.
Is he the doctor guy?
No, Jungkook was the rap hand guys. That you're like, oh.
You gotta be more a little bit.
Wait, he was singing?
Yeah.
This guy?
No, not this him, not guy? Him. Oh. The first one. You were like, because
speaking of vague comments, the BTS guy that does rap hands. Okay.
No, because then you.
I was about to say that.
See, it's not fun being on the other side, is it? It's not fun being on the other side. Sorry.
Wait, so you're talking about the guy who like touches his face and points a lot? Wait, which guy?
No, because you pointed him out first.
Okay.
Because then when he came out, you're like, oh man, this guy is the guy who like does his rap hands. Because that's why
he really, really puts on the rap hands. Mm. That guy. Okay.
Yeah.
This guy?
No, not him. No, not the really handsome guy.
He's Jungkook. Jung what?
Yeah, he's Jungkook.
Oh, you should just said the dead sexy ass motherfucker.
Yeah. Okay, sorry.
Policeman guy.
I know. Police. I mean, there's doctor, businessman.
Like, if this dude was a stripper, pilot. I would hire him.
Yeah.
Anyway,
dude is too handsome.
The guy that hits like the really high note. Also, right?
No, that's
not him.
That's the one, the red.
Good gosh.
But those two are the singers.
Yeah, they're like the main singers. But I really like the singing in this.
So how many singers do they have? Just two? Or do they have?
There's four.
There are four?
So four. So half of them are singers, half of them are rappers?
Huh. Oh, I thought most of them were rappers.
Wait, yeah. The only two rappers are Suga and Rapmon.
There's only two rappers?
And J-Hope. Three.
Oh, so three, pretty noticed. Much three out of the seven then.
Yeah, and then like Jungkook like does a little bit of both.
Mm. Yeah, so you have like half rappers, half singers.
Half.
Yeah.
All right. Anyway,
makes sense.
How about the music video?
I really liked it because it.
Did you see that reaction? She's like.
This is how
I used to be with Sonyeshide.
It's true.
With like SNSD. Yeah. And then it just, the fire died because the glass got shattered. And I got just thrown into the K-pop, like, darkness.
I mean, I would have just summarized as Girls' Generation hasn't been good in a while, I'd probably get killed for saying that.
You might have already been.
But, like, what's on? What about the.
Oh, the fact that it's almost like a one take.
Mm-hmm.
Or it's shot as a one take. So like when I watched it, I was like, oh my god, I had to like pause it and like watch it again. I was like, is this really a one shot? So I was like really like looking forward to the making to see how it was actually really shot. The dance is, it looks like the dance, like the members are having so much fun like dancing. Mm-hmm. Like you can see a few
they
kind of
like smirks on their faces.
But I mean, we all know BTS is known for the dancing. Yeah. So I was like really happy to see a lot of dancing in this. Mm-hmm. So,
All right.
Yeah.
What'd you think?
For me, I thought I wouldn't say this is the best BTS song I've heard, but it is pretty catchy. It's pretty good. I do have to say, but for me, what really makes it is the music video and the choreography. I've slowly become more and more kind of on the boat of Rap Monster's like rapping style. Mm-hmm. Like at first, I was kind of like, Rap Monster, what kind of name is that? And then like, okay, yeah, he can rap in Saturi, and that's kind of cool. But then like when he started doing his singles and his like solo projects, I was like, okay, this dude can rap. This dude is pretty good. He's got a pretty good flow. And I just really like the kind of music video directing. All the cuts that they use are very seamless. It just kind of flows into each other. And you don't realize that you're watching like just one cut. Like, because the problem with a group that has a lot of members, and I say a lot, that's like anything more than five, is that usually you have to partition the time between each member. And they did a really, really good job, I feel, in this song and music video, because when it was someone's turn to kind of like pop up and do their thing, the choreography and the directing like really, really just centered on that person. And I thought that was a really, really good job, especially the choreography. They're very like intertwined, if that makes any sense. Like the movements that they were doing it's one thing for one person and another person to do the same move at the same time, but for them to have choreography that's kind of like interlocked or like kind of moving together, mm-hmm. or like six guys down, one guy up, one guy back, one guy forward kind of deal. Like it really, really, really does groups that have like big members or a lot of members well. And I thought they did a really, 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 really good job with this music video and really, really good job with the choreography. And that's what makes it dope. But other than that, the music is kind of whatever for me.
Cringy.
How can I say this? So BTS for the longest time was kind of throwaway joke of like...
Yeah, we'd always joke around about them.
Yeah, like a group that like was just trying a little bit too hard to be like all gangster, like...
Yeah.
You know, we ribbity rap hands in it up. And I still remember their first debut song, and that video was just like, I think it bit me the wrong way. Yeah. It was like introducing them. They're all like, yo, we hard as fuck. My name's Rap Monster. And it's like,
We're bulletproof boys. And it's just
Yeah, it was just. And so it's crazy to me that like now, you know, I can say that this music video is probably my favorite boy group music video.
Wow, that's like,
I can't think of another boy group video where I was like watching it and I was like, I like this. Mm-hmm. Like, you know, EXO, of course the standard for a long time was EXO's
EXO's Growl. Yeah, Steven's favorite boy music video was Growl.
Yeah. And but I think that this, while it's, you know, EXO's Growl is a real one shot,
it's a real one shot, yes.
And you know how much I love my one shots. Like, yes. I thought they did a really good job for the most part of framing this dance. Like, I think the star of this is not the song. I don't like the song by itself that much.
Mm.
Like, if I'm listening to it, I guess I don't really like it that much. Mm. Maybe if I was a dancer and I could dance with it, I would be all up in this song, maybe. Mm-hmm. When I watch it, I think the director of this music video really, really, really played very well to the strengths of BTS, which is not only they're dancing, but they're dancing together, right?
Yeah.
And they did it, you know, long takes.
Yeah, extended cuts.
Really great. Yeah. That's what you need. Especially after their last music video, which didn't even have any dancing.
It didn't.
Yeah, right? Yeah. You just have that, like, lumberjack boy, and you're just like, what are you doing, right?
So true.
Now, I think maybe I like that song better in general.
Yeah, I think I like the song better as well.
As like a whole package, though, like I can't think of. Like, I think I watched this twice, which, like, right away, because I was like, A, I wanted to figure out how they did the cuts.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And B, I was just like, the dance, I think the choreography is so good. Mm-hmm. I don't know. I think it just matches sharp. So well. They dance it so well. Mm-hmm. It matches. Because, like, the chorus part with, like, meow, meow, meow. Like, that's a weird sound. I don't know if it's chorus. The dance break. Like, the kind of dance break every...
Oh, uh-huh.
Like, I don't know how to emulate it. No. It's like the maybe. But in the background there's just like this meow meow meow.
No,
meow
it kinda has this like fake saxophony kind of sound.
Yeah. It's very like strange to me. But for some reason like it works so well, I think, with their dance.
It's like kinda like a
it just kinda like on its own, I think I'd be a little like
what is this?
Like offended, like be like ugh. But I, for some reason, it's just, I think it all worked together very, very well. I can't believe it. I think, you know, I always, you know, heard that they were really good dancers. And I kind of saw it in some of the other videos.
Yeah,
but like, if you're going to give, if you're going to do a one shot, right, of a group, like, it makes total sense for it to be BTS. And like, it still amazes me that EXO did it 2 years ago and boy groups are like, no. I don't want to do that. I don't want to copy that. It's like, just, no. Like, if you can do it better, you should do it better. And I think this is better than Growl.
It just blows my mind that boy groups that are known for dancing don't have more dancing in their music videos. Mm-hmm. Like, when, like, I Need You, was that the last song? I Need You, when I came out and had no dancing, I was like, what are you doing? Like, BTS, like, this is not your forte, you know, just kind of looking like sexily at the camera or lumberjacky at the camera. Like, your forte is dancing. Now you go out and dance until people are tired of seeing you dance.
Yeah.
And when you're tired, people are tired of seeing you dance, then do something else, right?
Yeah.
Like, kind of like Shiny. Shiny, for the longest time, people were like, we heard you're great dancers, dance for us, monkeys, kind of deal, right? Yeah. And after a while, people are like, okay, Shiny can dance, but that's pretty much it.
Yeah.
We don't want to see them really dance anymore. And they kind of did something else, and we like that. Mm. So, but BTS, I still think you're in the like, kind of budding of your careers where people want to see you dance, you know. So dance your heart out because your choreography is good. You know, the synergy you have with, like, the members is good. So just show us that until we're like, okay, yeah, we've seen it all before.
Yeah, but for real though, like I mentioned this right away when we watched it again, but like the rap hands still bothers me, man. Like they
Rupert
just
Rappington.
It's
must be
too
a
much rap hands.
Tuition, man.
It's just so much. It's just like, we get it. You're a rapper. I got it.
But I do have to like defend them a little bit because when they have a camera just like pointed directly and like, okay, go. It's your solo time now. Like, what do you do with your hands?
Like, I think there's ways to do the rap hands that aren't so blatantly rap hands.
Mm.
Like, I don't know. Like,
like,
I mean, I'm not example. I am not a rapper. Right? But like, for example, if I like when we watch Verbal Jint rap, right? I mean, sometimes he puts a hand up, but he ain't all like, you know, like.
So you think
you know?
Just,
like, I think it's just less is more.
Yeah.
Less is more.
Okay, I'll agree with you.
Right,
less
be
is
a
more.
Little more like. You know, I'm sure
a little bit more conservative with rap hands,
yeah.
BTS. You
like
know?
Everybody does rap hands, right? Everybody does rap hands, but Like, I think the problem is like, because it has to be, right?
Yeah.
All the K-pop dances have to be choreographed to the T, right? Mm-hmm. To every smile is choreographed, to every smirk is choreographed, right? Like, to me it's a little too choreographed. Where I'm just like, all right, we get it. Like, someone was like, rap hands now. And they're like, okay, I'm on rap hands. You know?
At the point.
That's
point.
A very small, that's like a very personal thing. I do want to, you know, sum it and be like, still really great.
Yeah.
Can't believe I said that.
Less rap hands.
I look forward to, I mean, I've been looking forward to BTS's songs, weirdly enough, recently.
A little bit more and more, yeah.
But, you know, I'm sure the next one will probably be more of like a I Need You, and then they'll do another, right? You gotta, I'm sure they'll alternate a little bit. But I really, really did, like, this is now to me like the standard, I guess.
In boy group music
for
videos.
Boy group music videos. Because, like, while I think EXO dances very well, they have a very different style of dancing. Because
They have 12 guys versus 7, right?
They ain't got 12 no more. They ain't got 12 no more.
When they had Growl. No, when they had Growl.
Okay, I get you.
I'm comparing Growl.
Right, and, you know, they had us, but. You know, they did a smart thing and they separated a 6-6.
Man.
Like, that was pretty smart. But I just think the SM style of dancing, for some reason, sometimes I look at it and it's like too much. It's like too much. There's too many like hands and too many things. Like, I thought this was very, very hip hop, but it was very.
The right amount of.
Like I could see people maybe dance in a club. I mean, not like. I don't mean that like really, like 8 dudes coming out dancing like this, but like it seems more natural for this than like SMs, which are very more like this is choreography for K-pop. I don't know if that makes sense.
I think I know what you mean, because like BTS, their movements aren't very like kind of flaily. They're very tight and like kind of sharp.
Mm-hmm.
Like tight and sharp is like, if we compare it to like Teen Tops, their legs were just like flailing all over
like
the place, right?
Like octopus.
Yeah, world. Right. Like I was joking, like Neo was the blowfish and they were all octopus and all around. But BTS, their movements are very kind of like kind of sharp and angular and tight. And this choreography is the best way I could describe it.
Mm.
So it seems a little bit like less is more kind of deal.
Yeah. But I thought it was really good. So let's move on then to the next song, which is Big Bang with their song Sober. Now, Sober. Big Bang, I think this is the first time, this is their fourth month of release. No, third month.
Four? Third. Loser.
Third
month. And of course, Loser was like our favorite song.
Yeah.
And then even... you know, two episodes ago, we were still, like, you really liked Bang Bang Bang. I mean, in the episode, you really liked Bang Bang Bang. No?
Not really.
I think you should go back and listen. I remember very clearly, because...
I said it was good. It grew on me, but I didn't say I really liked it more than, like, Loser.
No, I never said you liked it more than Loser, but I remember you saying it was better than... Bebe and better than We Like to Party.
No, I like We Like to Party more than Bing, 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 Bing.
I don't know.
Yeah,
we need to go back. I remember you saying you liked it. I'm not saying you loved it. You wanted to marry it. All right.
I liked it a decent amount. We can say that.
I lost my train of thought now because I thought I was just making a normal thing. Doesn't matter. All that matters is this time nobody picked. This as their favorite song of the week.
It was supposed to be their main release, right?
What did you think about Sober, Mina?
I was, well, because then when I heard that it was going to be called Sober, I was like, oh, they're going to be sober and not drunk. And
it might be like
which you don't like,
song.
Right? You don't like being sober. I get it.
Oh, okay.
Well, I thought, but then... When you actually listen to it, it's actually talking about, like, not being able to be sober. Like, it's hard being sober because I miss you.
Oh, is it about missing somebody?
Yeah.
Would not have gotten that from the music video.
Yeah, yeah. Exactly.
Yeah, when I looked at the lyrics, it felt kind of like, it's like Big Bang wrote this song about their current lives kind of deal. Like... It might be like a love story kind of song, but it kind of felt like people around me are so fake, like, you know, having such a hard time, like, I can't trust anyone kind of deal. I'm just like, are you writing this about your own life, Big Bang? Like this seems like too real for me, you know?
Mm. But I mean, did you like the song? Like, how would you rank it? With the other Big Bang.
Main series.
Yeah,
main series. Out of all the other ones, I would say this one would be in the middle.
Then what's on the bottom?
The bottom for me is Bang Bang Bang.
Hmm. I mean, don't look at me. I never really liked that song, but
yeah,
I still remember a lot of people were like, this is my fucking shit. I'm gonna hype this song for the rest of my life. And then like 2 weeks later, it was like,
I always
like Loser more. Because like,
we did a reaction for that, right?
We did.
Bang, bang, bang. Yeah.
We did. Yeah.
And I remember us not really.
We didn't really like it at first.
Yeah.
But I remember after that, you said you listened to it a lot more, and you and Anna were like, yeah, bang, bang, bang. And I was like,
I really like the bang, out, bang, out, bang, out part. And the bang, bang, bang part. That's pretty much the only part.
I did say I really liked the dance, though. I thought the dance was
really good. Oh, yeah. We did say that. I watched the dance practice.
And I was like, that's pretty.
Yeah.
I thought it matched the song really well.
Yeah. For me, I wouldn't say this is middle of the pack. I would say it's like on the lesser end of songs. Just because it's very forgettable for me. Because I don't want to say it doesn't have the catchiness, because it does have catchiness to it. But it's just something is missing. I don't know what it is. Like, there's just something about this song that I'm just not really sold on, I guess.
I mean, I think part of that is, like, the genre of the song, right? It's a very, like, kind of, like, chill, kind of, like, kind of turn it on in the background. You're kind of just like, nah, nah. You know, just like, nah. You know, you're not bang, 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 right? You're not, like, hype off your ass. It's, you're not kind of, like, sad, right? Kind of like Loser is. Yeah. And kind of, it's kind of just, like, very, you know, flowy. And, but that also means that there's nothing particularly grabbing, I think, from it. And of course, you know, we all agree, You may not, and a lot of people sure don't, but this song sounds very similar to another great song.
Yeah.
I wonder what that is.
And so sometimes when I hear this song, I'm like, do I like this song because of this song or because I like that other song that it sounds like?
So today we figured out what song it was, right?
Sure.
But when I first heard the song, I was like, this song sounds like a song I know. Nope. And I liked that song for a little bit, and then I stopped liking that song. What was that song? Yeah. Right? And when you kind of hear that in a song, it's not really a good thing, right? Like, originality is kind of king when it comes to, like, art and all that. But, yeah, this song just seemed very, very, very similar to that song.
Oh. I mean, I don't want to beat it. I mean, the song is The Wanted. Yeah.
Glad You Came.
Yeah. Right? And, like, I personally don't think it was plagiarism, but I think it was whether consciously or unconsciously, it was very heavily inspired by. Because it sounds so similar.
Yeah.
It sounds too similar
to not
be nothing. Like, like, there are a lot of Big Bang fans, like, as we know, as I've experienced, they're very fervent in their love to Big Bang. And so when people are like, they sound nothing alike, like, that's some bullshit.
That is,
like,
bullshit.
Like, I don't think it's the same, but they sound pretty similar.
Like, seriously, if you say they sound nothing alike, like, you really have to stretch. No, you don't really have to stretch. The only things that are really different is, like, the BPM is a little bit different. And also, one song goes high and one song goes low at the end.
Yeah.
And that is pretty much the only difference.
Yeah.
Like, they sound very, very, very similar to a point where it's just kind of like, this song does remind that song. Mm-hmm. But I, like Steven, wouldn't call it plagiarism because there's enough different things about it for it to be not plagiarism, but
because it's like they like change. It's like a different genre a little bit, right? Mm-hmm. They add in more rocky kind of elements. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Big Bangs, that is. So, I mean, so that part, I really like that part. You know, the da, 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 right? I really like that part. I think it's really catchy. I don't know if it's catchy because of the Wanted thing or because of this song. I don't know. But I also did really like T.O.P.'s rapping part.
Oh, yeah.
I thought for some reason it matched really well in this song. Yeah. What he was doing in the music video, I don't fucking know.
So let's talk about the music video next. What did you think about the music video?
I mean, this is just, to me, it's a Big Bang music video. There's probably 18,000 pages of symbolism somewhere in this video, but for all I know, it's just kind of weird. And it's just kind of Big Bang being Big Bang, you know? Like when you were like saying I can't be sober because I'm sad about a girl, I would never have gotten that from this video. Yeah. Like, it sounds like I will never be so sober
because
it's
I
just
love
too damn
drugs.
Fun to be drunk as fuck, right? Or I don't know what T.O.P. is doing, but that's not drunk he's doing.
Yeah,
he's got weird mushrooms or ecstasy.
He's got weird psychedelic hands, you know? Yeah. Where people are taking psychedelics and their hands are kind of like weirdness and shit.
So, like, a lot of it's weird because a lot of it to me is like, it's not drunk, right? It's like high on some shit.
Yeah. Well, sober doesn't necessarily mean.
True, it doesn't mean alcohol.
Yeah.
But, you know. It sure doesn't mean funny smelling cigarettes. How would they know?
Someone put some funny smelling smoke in this shower. You know what I'm saying?
But I do, like, I kind of, I haven't gone back and actually listened to We Like to Party. Which also sounded very much like a Beverly Hills, like a Weezer song, right? Yeah. Like, it seems like, you know, it's great on GD for trying to branch out, but it kind of sounds like his branching out is like, I heard this song, yeah. I'm going to make my version of that song, yeah. And I don't know.
You just got to be really careful, because, like, yeah, a lot of artists, when they are learning something new, they want to copy, like, someone who's done it and are great, right? Like, when I first learned how to play guitar, I wouldn't go straight into writing my own songs. That'd be almost impossible. I'd have to be like a genius to do that. Like,
which I just, you aren't.
Yeah, I'm not.
You dumb bitch.
Wow, Steve.
Sorry, I was still angry from the phone.
But what I mean is, like, I just copied and learned how to play songs of, like, great people. But
you're not selling those songs.
Yeah, but that will influence my style, right?
True.
And
true.
When, you know, Big Bang is trying to borrow from different genres, and they do sound very similar, you gotta be really, really careful to put your own stank on it. You know, you can't just copy the style directly. And yeah. Big Bang is, or whoever's writing these songs, are kind of like teetering on that, like, okay, yeah. You need to put a little bit of your own stank on it, a little bit more of your stank, you know?
Yeah, there's like a little bit of stank, but not enough to be like, to really set it.
Separate it, to be like, this is a Big Bang song, it doesn't sound like that song.
Yeah.
Right. But what did you think of the music video, Mina?
Eh.
Eh.
Hmm.
Eh. I don't know how I feel about Hyang's hair, though.
Oh, yeah, I know how exactly
how I feel about that hair.
Which one's worse, T.O.P.'s hair in Loser or Taeyang's hair now?
No, not Loser.
Not Loser.
Bebe. Oh, no.
Well, it was for both,
Bebe,
right?
Bebe, yeah. But Bebe was more on
display. Was it more Bebe?
Yeah.
Was it
Bebe? No, it was Loser.
And Bebe.
No, Bebe, he had
Loser,
a different
he
haircut.
Had, like,
he had the two
horns. You're right.
But Bebe, he had
the Sideshow Bob hair.
Yeah, the Sideshow Bob hair.
Yeah.
Which one's worse to you?
Which one's worse?
T.O.P. Sideshow Bob or Taeyang?
Yeah,
I'm a 5-year-old girl or maybe a Jamaican. I don't know.
I would have to say Taeyang's.
Is worse?
Yeah.
Worse.
Hmm.
You heard it here first.
Which one do you think is worse?
Taehyung's by far. Yeah, because, like, T.O.P.'s hair just kind of seems like he had a bad hair day. It's like, okay, one of them sticks up here. But Taehyung, he deliberately made it look like that. Like, no. No.
I might still have to go with T.O.P.
Hmm.
I don't know why. I don't know why. I just, whenever I see that T.O.P. hair, I'm just like, someone give me some fucking scissors, please.
I'm just gonna cut that tip off.
Please. Like, I don't think I met a single person that was like, T.O.P. looks good in it. Like, I don't, yeah. Even hardcore T.O.P. fans were like, no.
Please, oh no. God, please, no. No.
But some girls might be into cornrows. Or not cornrows, whatever they're, what,
like dreads.
Dreads.
Yeah.
All right. Oh.
I heard that the director who filmed this was supposed to film 2 p.m.'s Come to My House.
Yeah.
But he didn't.
Well, the problem with that story is the timing. Because, yeah, like 2PM's video got delayed. Mm-hmm. And we didn't know. We talked about it was being delayed, but yeah. We didn't know why. And that was because one of our commenters was like, the director dropped out like 3 days before they were going to shoot it, which delayed their whole comeback. And that director happens to be the guy that shoots Big Bang videos.
Yeah.
But then a lot of people are saying, like, while that looks shady, like, you don't know when this video was shot, and you don't know when, blah, blah, blah. But I do think it's, regardless of whatever happened, like, it still looks really bad for a director to cancel on anybody, right?
Yeah, exactly.
Like, so it really, really sucks for 2PM because they got their comeback delayed, which could have affected them a lot, right?
Yeah.
I think luckily they still kind of came out at a time where it wasn't this crazy nonsense time. The fact that, you know, this video now came out afterwards is kind of like, timing. But, you never know.
Well, let's go on to our second Big Bang release. This one didn't have a music video, but it is Big Bang's with If You. Now, Big Bang's If You is a more sad, acoustic-y sounding song. Doesn't have a video, as we said. But for me, I like this song better out of the two. Just because I like sad songs sometimes. And this song really, really spoke to me. Like, it stirred up some, like, deep emotions with, like, my past experiences. Yeah. Right? So it really, really, like, touched me in a personal way. But I do understand people who don't understand the lyrics, who don't necessarily have the same experiences or can't feel those experiences from this song. It can get very boring because it's literally them just singing, which T.O.P. is has a good voice, but he's not necessarily a singer, right? He's a rapper. So this song might be very boring for some, and also just meh, right? I know you felt a personal connection as well. Mina, yeah. What do you feel like?
Well, I think if anybody who's going through a breakup, if they listen to the song, it's even more sad for them.
Yeah.
So, I really liked the song when it came out, and then it was like, I downloaded it right away, and then it was on repeat for like the whole day.
Me too.
And then
me
we were too. Talking about another song. I'm like, I'm not even listening to that song. I'm only listening to this right now. But, yeah, I really liked it. I really like Sungri's voice in it.
Mm-hmm.
I think he played a huge part in the song.
In the feeling, general feeling.
Yeah, but I think my favorite part. Favorite part is Daesung's part because I don't know. For me, like when Top started and after Top was Sungri, like they were like really soft and like.
Just kind of like,
Yeah, and then GD's chorus, and then Daesung just comes in, and his voice is, like, really raspy. And
it's kind of crack, it's, like, almost cracking, like, you
yeah,
know.
And then it sounds like, because at his part, he's, like, a little bit angry because, or not, like, angry, but he's, like, are you hurting, like, me, too? Like, I should forget you, or whatever.
Yeah, if you like this song, you should really look at the lyrics. It'll give it a deeper meaning to it. I really recommend looking at the lyrics.
Yeah. But I don't know. For him, for his part, it just sounded like he is like, I'm in so much pain. Like, I can feel the emotions from his part. So I really liked his part.
Yeah. And I feel like this is one of those songs, like, if you can't feel the emotion, like, if you can't sympathize with the emotional feeling that you get, like, from hearing a certain person's voice or the way they sing, then you're really not going to appreciate this song.
Mm-hmm.
For me, I kind of got similar feelings. Like, Daesung's part was technically singing-wise, like, not very good. Like, it sounds like he's almost about to crack. Like, his voice is about to crack. And, like, it sounds, like, almost pitchy at some points. But that's kind of, like, the style that you want to emulate, like, a lot of emotion, right? So I felt the same way. But Steven, on the other hand, he did not feel those emotions.
Yeah, he did a good job of completely prefacing. Like, Steven's going to say something in a second.
Well,
please understand that if this and this and this and this happens, don't give him a hard time.
No, because, I mean, there's two ways to look at the song, and I feel like I'm kind of in the middle road, right?
Sure.
Like, I could feel those things, but not to that extent. I wouldn't kind of, put into words all those things and, like, try to describe every little thing.
Sure.
But I could feel the general, feeling of the song, the general meaning of the song. But on the other hand, I'm like, okay, if you're just listening to it, you don't understand the lyrics, you don't have those experiences, this song's going to be really, really boring for you, kind of a deal. So, Steven, what did you feel like?
Yeah, I don't know any Korean, so I don't understand the song.
Mm-hmm.
I pretty much everything you said, Mina, I don't feel any of that. I don't feel any of that. Now, I'm not saying it's not there for you, right?
Yeah.
Because, you know, again, ballads are not necessarily my thing, but that doesn't mean I don't like, some of my favorite, when I'm sad, kind of songs, I'm like, time for a ballad or a whiny pop song, you know. I just don't feel any of those emotions from their voices. Like, Because I know when you first heard it, you're like, oh man, I'm hearing, like, oh, he's like about to crack and he's about this, and I can feel the pain in his voice. And I'm like, I don't feel none of that.
This is fine.
Like, maybe it's because, like, recently I was watching a lot of K-Pop Star 4, and K-Pop Star 4 had, like, these, like, 8 ballad singers that, like, whenever they sang, I was like, holy shit, did someone murder your family? Like, I can feel the pain in all your voices, and I'm like, damn, that's crazy. I just don't, you know, I don't expect that from Big Bang, right? They're not that type of singer, and I'm just like, I can't give them the benefit of the doubt. It's like, well, it's Big Bang, and they're doing it, you know, good for them, but I just didn't feel any, feel any of that kind of emotion. I felt more in Loser than I feel in this song. Like, it's a different kind of pain, I think.
Yeah.
But that, I think that's more like loneliness. You know, Loser's more like loneliness. Yeah. But, like, I did feel something from that song that I don't really feel.
I do have to comment on something that you remind me of, Steven. Like, a lot of Korean bands and music, just in general, like, if you are known as a ballad singer, it's really hard to, like, stretch out of a different lane. You know, you have to stay in your lane. Kind of like, if you're a ballad singer or OST singer, you're going to be known as an OST singer. If you do something different, people will be like, why are you doing that? You're an OST singer. And Big Bang, although they do have some sad songs, like, when people think Big Bang, they think, like, party, this jump around. And so when you hear a song like this, you're not expecting to feel the emotions that you get from, like, a ballad song, right? So on that, I can understand what you mean, Steven. Like, I would probably feel more touched by the way ballad singers would sing certain songs. But I guess the reason why this song speaks to me so much is because I know all the lyrics when I first heard it, because they're not very difficult. But, and those, like, really resonated with, like, my personal experiences, that's why.
Mm. I mean, I've read the lyrics, and... Yeah. But reading the lyrics is not the same as
understanding
it
when you first hear it at the same time, right?
But I just kind of think, you know, it's Big Bang, right? Like, I don't want to hear Big Bang sing a generic ballad song, right? Like, I want to hear Big Bang. Like, if I want to hear a sad Big Bang song, like, I think Bad Boy is a good version. Loser is a good example of, like, their stank on a sad
Big Bang
song.
Style sad song.
And so maybe I need to listen, because I haven't heard this that much. Maybe, like, twice or three times. Maybe I'll like it more. Maybe if I'm in a sadder mood, you know, maybe if I, you know, but right now I just want a party. It's summertime, you know, so my mood is not personally into this. So that's probably why I just didn't like it as much.
Okay.
I don't know. How many more? I mean, it's going to, obviously an E is next, right?
Yeah.
And then the full album's going to come out. Are there going to be any new songs on that full album, or is E the end and then the full album is the compilation?
I'm not sure. That's something we need to ask.
We should ask Anna. So we have a friend, Anna. She's a really, really big Bang fan. Mm. She would probably know, but we don't know.
I mean, I'm really, like, honestly, at least for me personally, like, Loser is the only Big Bang song that I still care to listen to.
Yeah, that, like, song is good.
Like, I mean, I know I wasn't a huge fan of the other ones as much as some other people are, right, in the world, but, like, I'm not going to turn on Bang Bang Bang, and I'm not going to turn on, maybe We Like to Party, maybe, but, you know, Sober, maybe I'll just listen to The Want, you know, like, I can sing to that song, you know, so I don't know. I'm really hoping for the E, right, like, there's at least one more song that I really want, because I still think, I still have some hope. I mean, I don't know. Do you still listen to any of the other Big Bang songs?
I listen to Loser still.
Loser, but not the other ones?
Yeah, not the other ones.
Mm. How about you?
Same for me.
Same?
I only listen, well, besides the new ones, I only listen to Loser.
All right, well, it's a little sad if you didn't have a music video, though.
Yeah.
Because, like, I mean, this song is not even posted on their channel, right?
Yeah.
Like, you have to go to some third party or a third party person for it. But I think a lot of people are saying they like If You more than Sober. But seriously though, in Sober, what was he doing with the goat?
I don't know.
What was he doing with the goat?
He's trying to get some goat butt.
All right. Well, now it's normally the middle, but it's like the 2/3 mark now.
Yeah.
But we want to directly thank all the people that support us and listen to us every single episode. And of course, the best of those people left us a message on iTunes or a review, not really a message, but they left us a review on iTunes. So, this week we got 2 new reviews. And so I want to read one from Trebiv? Trebiv?
Treble?
Trebvi?
Trebvi?
Well, Trebvi says, this podcast is one of the best podcasts I've listened to.
Oh, thank you. It is
informative and a must-have for any K-pop fans. The hosts are very informative and give their general honest opinion about songs without a significant bias, except for Steven and Brave Sound.
Lol.
Which may come in handy in a little bit.
Okay.
But we want to, of course, thank you, Trebiv, for leaving us that review.
Yeah. So our next review is from Maggie AFR. Grown people listen to K-pop. Do you know how annoying it is to hear the same five songs over and over? So stumbling upon TWIK this week in K-pop was a pleasant surprise. Yes, they confused me at first, as we do many people. They say wordy nerds. I think they meant dirty words.
Wordy nerds.
Probably because they are in their 20s. You guessed right, we are in our 20s.
Not in Korea. I'm 30 in Korea.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Oh, really?
Yeah, he's 30.
Yeah.
I play this podcast while doing all the mundane stuff that keeps my family and home functional, like ironing, cooking, cleaning, and tuning out loud kids, etc. I'm glad that we can be that to you, Maggie.
Yep.
We really are touched by some of the reviews that people leave because me and Steven, we never really expected people to say such nice things about us at one point when we were doing this. We were getting mostly hate. And it's we really, really can't express in words how, like, just keep up the work, good work, guys. Like, really, really got us through some of those hard times. We're just like, yeah, we do have some fans who like listening to what we do.
Yeah.
And we really, really want to say thank you. We appreciate you listening to us. Steve, you got anything to say?
Yeah, I mean, there was a point where we kind of really tried to do a lot of things on YouTube. We were trying to get a new audience that way. But the specifically the people that download our podcast, like you guys, have stuck with us this whole time, and we love you, love you, love you, love you. All the people that leave us iTunes reviews, especially, but all the people that continue to download our episodes every single week or every single episode, really, like, I can't tell you how much I love you. I recently listened to, like, a random episode of, like, me and Kelvin back, like, episode number 4 or whatever, episode number 3, and dear God, it was fucking hilarious. I'm a little sad, like, because Kelvin had asked me a long time ago to take down his episodes just because he was, like, looking for a new job.
Yeah.
And so he didn't want, like, the weird off chance that, like, his employer would, like, find this or whatever. So I took them all down, but it was very different and funny because I remember being like, all right, Kelvin, oh, man, like, this is blah, blah, blah. They're awesome. And he's like, eh, I didn't like it. I'm like, yo, man, why not? He's like, they're ugly. I'm like, oh, okay. All right. Good job, Kelvin. So if you guys want to help us out, please leave us an iTunes review because it helps us in the searches, right? The more reviews we have, the higher we're on the search engine, which is very important. And number two, it lets us know what you guys think.
Yeah.
We got a lot of people that said to look into kind of the chapter function on iTunes. And so for this episode, I will try and do that. I don't actually know how to do that. I don't know how hard it is to do that,
but we'll figure it out.
I'm gonna try and do it just for you guys. So thanks for leaving us the review. Right, Mina? There were a couple of reviews that were like, I love
bring
Mina. Bring Mina back.
I love Mina. Bring Mina back.
I know
back.
You don't listen to the podcast, you know, but people did say that. So
yeah, people were saying nice things about you, Mina.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah.
More nice things than they've ever said about us.
If you want, you can just send us her alcohol. She'll really enjoy that.
Yeah. Like, if you ever want to send us presents, like, you should send her me food. Send
hats.
No, I got plenty of those. You don't need to send me any more hats. Send me an alcohol. Send Steven ranch, preferably.
Ooh, ranch.
Preferably ranch.
Dude, I got so mad. Like, my mom sent me some ranch, right? And I was like, fuck yeah, more ranch. And then the problem was I use the ranch and I leave it on my table and I forgot to put it back in the refrigerator. And so I had to throw out like a whole bottle
of ranch.
And I was like, no!
I had one of my friends bring me like 5 bottles of ranch, and they're the wrong type of ranch.
What do you mean, the wrong type of ranch?
It's not the good kind.
Was it like generic, like Albertson's ranch? I don't know if you have Albertson's in California.
Yeah, it's kind of like some off-brand ranch. It's not Hidden Valley.
Not like Hidden Valley.
Yeah. Shout out to Hidden Valley if you want to sponsor us. Me and Steve would love your ranch.
Dude, I would bathe in that.
Like, seriously, I eat that ranch with everything.
Yeah. But I mean, I'm from Texas. Like, I eat everything with ranch. Pizza with ranch. Hot dogs with ranch.
Yeah.
Yes,
sir.
Everything. Chicken nuggets with ranch.
Chicken nuggets. Yes, sir.
Burgers with ranch.
I put ranch on my lasagna. Yes, sir.
Oh, I don't do that.
No, it's good.
That sounds good, though.
Trust me. Like, so what you do is when you make your lasagna and you put in, like, a layer of, tomato sauce, alternate the layer. Some people put, like, fettuccine alfredo sauce, but I put, like, some ranch in there.
Huh.
Some American cooking right there.
I don't know if I'm that bold, but if you make it, yeah. I'll eat it.
It's good,
I'll
man.
All right, well, speaking of stuff that I like, let's move on to my choice for my favorite song of the episode. Now,
what be that, Steven?
I wonder.
I'm so prepared for this. Like, I've been thinking about this for 2 weeks, right? Now, for a week and a half, I was not going to pick this song.
Oh.
I was probably going to pick Sistar or BTS. Right.
Wow.
Okay. So part of the reason I picked this was because I knew she would pick BTS, and I didn't know what you were gonna pick, but I thought if you didn't pick Sistar, I might have still picked Sistar.
Mm-hmm.
But you know, then the last 3 days, like something flipped in my head. All right. And part of that was like, is me, I think, trying to defend all of Brave Sound to all the people that hate Brave Sound.
Maybe.
And so I think part of me picking this song is in a defense of Brave Sound, but here we go. So the song that I love the most is AOA's new song, Heartbreak. No, Heart Attack. Heart Attack. The mic was blocking the thing. I couldn't see. It's called Heart Attack.
Heartbreak.
Well, the thing is, they never say it in English, right? So, like, in my head, I don't know what it's called. Is it called Heart Attack? Or is it called Shinkun? Right? Like, that's fine. Yeah, whatever.
It's the leg. You can't see it, but it's the leg part.
So, of course, AOA.
Yeah, put it in your boobies. Oh, sorry.
Thank you.
That was really
Thank
loud.
You. Sorry. So, AOA, we talk about AOA all the time.
Yes.
They have the both good and the bad associated with them, right?
Yeah.
The bad, I think a lot of people in the last couple of months, at least what I've seen, like on Reddit and on comments, like people are kind of sick of Brave Sound.
Yeah.
Even though Brave Sound actually hasn't released that many songs in the last 6 months.
Yeah.
But there was a point last year where Brave Sound released 8 billion songs.
Yeah, I remember that time.
And 3 of them happened to be AOA's last 3 singles.
Yeah.
And those 3 singles happened to be the 3 that turned AOA from
into a
D tier to one of the next, like, S tiers, right?
Yeah.
They're not there yet.
They're definitely A tier now.
Wait a couple of years, they might be. And so when this song, you know, because the AOA, notoriously, they didn't take a break for an entire year. They released 3 singles in 1 year, which is pretty unheard of.
Yeah.
And so they finally took a break, and this was their big comeback. And, of course, it was like, it's Brave Sound again.
Not surprising.
For everybody else, but for me, I'm like, hot damn. Give me some of that. I'm so hyped for that shit.
Give me some of that Brave Sound.
And I will say, when I first heard this song, I really didn't like it. Yeah. Really didn't like it.
Okay.
I think the go-to thing, and I do agree, sort of, that there's a lot of sounds. There's a lot of sounds.
Mm-hmm.
There's a lot of layering that probably shouldn't need to be layered.
Yeah.
There's a lot of electronic shit in your face. I fully understand that. I experienced that the first time I heard it. I was like, dear God, what is wrong with you, Brave Sound? Are you deaf in 1 ear and you just didn't know?
Mm-hmm.
Or what? But on subsequent listens, and the more I kind of were getting into the song, like, the first 2 seconds still gets me. The first 2 seconds, I'm like, whoa! Oh, okay, all right. But
I was like, whoa!
After you
calms down
you
a little
slowly
bit.
Just, it just kind of disappears.
Mm-hmm.
Like, truthfully and honestly, like, it just kind of disappears to me, and I get into what I love about Brave Sound. And I never really, I don't think ever could speak, like, this is why I love Brave Sound, but this is why I like Brave Sound,
okay? Tell us why.
I love Brave Sound because in all parts of the song,
mm-hmm.
not just the chorus, but the verse, like parts in between the verse, there's there's always something that is catchy in the entire song to me.
Okay.
There's always like a quick little hey, right? Or there's always a kind of syncopation that they do with their voice or with their sound that like there's always something that I can attach to with the song and I can kind of get into it. And I think that this song has that. Like my problem with Sistar's song was that some of it feels like filler.
Okay.
But this song is always moving forward. This song is like doom, 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 and it's just always going forward. And that's what I wanted in a summer song.
Okay, fair enough.
And I really, really like it. So yeah, that's what I like.
Okay, so for me, when I first heard the song, I want to say I hated it, but I was really, really disappointed. Because I've liked all of AOA's songs pretty much until this point, and was really looking forward to the next song, and this song kind of didn't meet expectations for me. Like Steven, it was really, really, really noisy. The layering that Brave Sound did was very, very bad, and it really reminded me of why I don't like Tiara songs. Like, some Tiara songs are just really, really noisy, and for me, but it still had enough catchiness that I would listen to it. It wasn't terrible, I wouldn't say. But it was good enough for me to listen to it a few more times. And kind of like Steven, I think my brain kind of just started to filter out all that noise. And like things that I first heard when I listened to the song, like they're really less noticeable nowadays or when I listen to it now. But I wouldn't go as far to say I like the song a lot. I definitely like Sistar much more than this. Any of AOA's releases much more than this. But I do have to say...
you heard that first one, though?
First one, Elvis?
Elvis.
Yeah, this is like on the par of Elvis for me.
Oh, that is
this is like
so on wrong.
Elvis. Well, maybe a little bit better than Elvis. But I do have to say... The song did grow on me because it's been out for 2 weeks now, but I wouldn't say I love this song. Definitely not.
Like, I think, I totally understand, right, why I think other people, but I think for me, really, like, this is one of those songs where, like, when I'm singing it in the shower or I'm singing it, like, I'm not always singing the chorus. And for 99% of the K-pop songs that we like, it's always
chorus.
The verse is kind of, but that chorus is where it's at, catchy, yeah. Right? And for me, it's like the chorus, I think the chorus is catchy, but there's also the part before the chorus. You know, the da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. I'm not a good singer, right?
So you feel like the song itself, it does have a lot of
there are many parts,
but the way it's arranged is...
I think there's multiple parts to that I can attach to and that I enjoy. Like I really enjoy the rap, Jimin's rap. Like I think it matches really well with the song, and it doesn't sound like a totally random ass rap that comes out of nowhere. I mean, Mina's face was like, I didn't fucking like it, and I understand her voice is her voice, right?
Oh, yeah.
Some people really don't like Jimin's rapping voice, which is fair.
Like, I totally understand that. I mean, I think I've just heard it so much that I'm just like, you know, she's the motherfucking top meta. Like, I can't. And I've heard it so much, right? I'm okay with it. But I do agree that the start of this song is like, if someone doesn't like Brave Sound, if someone doesn't like the kind of whiny voice that AOA does in general, like, the start of this song is really bad for that. Because it starts really noisy, and it starts really whiny.
Yeah.
And so I think a lot of people who don't like that already are like, whoop, we done.
Yeah, like I kind of compare this song to like Big Bang's If You. Like, if you like AOA, if you like Brave Sound and the type of songs that they make, like, and you're looking for a specific thing, like, you will really like this song. Like, this song is really popular in Korea right now. Because it really resonates with like a lot of people, because they like the fun, they like AOA, there's like enough catchiness to them, there's like da-da-das in there, and people like it. And on the other hand, like Mina will say in a few seconds, it doesn't resonate with them, right? So Mina, you really didn't like the song.
Yeah.
Why?
It just wasn't to my, I don't know, cousin, we have a group chat,
yeah.
And when it came out, I wasn't planning to listen to it.
But you didn't like a lot of the other AOA songs, right? Or you did?
Not really. I liked Miniskirts.
Okay.
But the other ones, it's just...
Or it was like So-So.
Yeah, it was like So-So. Yeah. But when you were like, I'm so disappointed, I'm like, oh, well, I guess I'm like, I'm going in. Like, let me check it out. I'm like, oh, okay.
I see why Josh is disappointed.
Yeah. Like, because how you said it was like a really trashy Tiara song or something like that.
I don't know. I don't know if I said trashy, but it's very kind of like noisy Tiara.
Yeah.
It's like a Tiara song, I'm like, that's fucking bogus. But... if you're talking about a Tiara song where there's too much noise, I kind of get what you're saying.
That's what I mean. Yeah. I don't mean this is like electronic.
It doesn't sound like, Tiara is so electronic-y and boop, 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 boop. And I'm
But Tiara songs I attribute with noise. And so when I say a song sounds like a Tiara song, I'm thinking like electronically it's layered too much is what I mean.
I would think it's just not a good song. So
but anyways, so you're saying it's noisy and... Tiara, maybe not, but it's noisy.
Yeah, it was like really noisy. But like, I mean, I don't like hate it.
Yeah.
Like because that was when I was walking down the street.
Hey, walking down the street, got
it. The song came on and I was like singing along with it. I was like, oh my god, I'm singing along to it. Like I didn't expect for me to like actually remember any of it.
Yeah.
But that Shin Kong
hit.
That part is really good.
Yeah, for
like I actually to speak on the street thing, like I actually that noise like doesn't really show up on like shitty speakers.
It doesn't.
Yeah.
So like when you're like on the street or like when you're listening to it on speakerphone or you're listening to it like not directly into your ear holes, like I think it really helps and it kind of
it does actually. And a lot of times I feel like walking around in Korea, like if you hear a song in headphones, like you're like, this song's not really for me. And you're walking down the street, you're like, what is this song? And you look it up, you're like, ooh, embarrassed. Like that's happened to me a few times and it's happened to her, obviously. Mm-hmm. And I'm sure that's happened to Steven a few times.
Yeah.
And this is one of those songs where it's really noisy and there's a lot of things not to like about it. But there's also a fair amount of catchiness to it. So I can understand why Steven really, really likes it because it has all that Brave sound catchiness. But for me,
it's not as good. It's not as good as Miniskirt Short Hair or Like a Cat. Hands down, it's not as good.
See, that's my qualm with it. Like, I was expecting that quality of song. And that's kind of what happens when you listen to a lot of K-pop. You kind of expect certain things out of things. And like, even if it is a good song, like, if it didn't really meet your expectations, then it's not as
Right. But for me, in this 2005 death era that we've kind of...
2005?
Like, 2015. Sorry, guys. It's 2015 death era. Like, there's not that many of these type of songs that's been released. And, like,
true.
I thought Sistar would be one, but Sistar is a fun song, but it's not an upbeat song.
What do you mean by that?
Like it's... Sistar's song is like a... Nah, it's a kind of a slow song. It's like a nah, nah, we're all kind of chanting together. But this song is like duh, 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 duh. It's like I can get into this song.
I see what you mean.
I can. I'm kind of like if I'm gonna run or something, I'd probably listen to this song. I probably won't listen to Sistar song.
Yeah, like Sistar sounds fun. It doesn't necessarily sound upbeat. Right?
Yeah.
I know what you mean.
Now the music video, like
Woo-hoo!
I mean, AOA has slowly, progressively discover that they're hot as fuck, right?
Yeah.
And this is like the epitome of that in maybe not a good way.
No, it wasn't a good way.
Probably not in a great way. But the music video, I mean, is kind of meh. I mean, it's like hot girls that look hot. Just like a lot of boy group videos are hot, cute guys that look cute, right? Or hot boys. I just don't want to say hot boys. That sounds
handsome
weird.
Boys looking handsome.
Yeah, handsome boys.
Handsome dudes looking handsome, right?
Right. Like, this was a very much like, yo, I mean, we all know New Soyeon was hot, right?
Yeah.
But did you know other girls are really hot, too? And it's just kind of like, all right, I kind of get it. You guys do look hot.
You guys are hot. God damn, you're hot.
Yeah.
Like, for real, though. As much as I harp on, like, girl groups, like, doing things that are super blatant and like very sexualized and kind of like butt shots or really kind of cheap shots. I'll call them cheap shots, you know, because they're just like showing a sexy, this scene is supposed to be sexy, right?
Yeah.
Like as much as I like really harp on that, like this video got me though. It's like, god damn, they're hot. Like, shit. Yeah. Like,
but like I, you know, I watched the dance practice. Like part of my like, remember I said like a week and a half, I was like, eh. But part of that tumble into I like this song was that I did actively look at more things. I was like, I want to check out this dance practice video. Uh-huh. I'm going to check out their performances. And, you know, I'm slowly like,
you know. You got to be careful, Steven. That's how you fall into K-pop forever.
That's true.
How you
fall. It's true. But I purposely.
I'm on the edge of two of AOA because, you know, they've been putting out a lot of songs I like, you know.
One of the girls hurt my soul. I don't. I'm down. I'm done. I'm done with that, right? Yeah. But like.
One of the girls hurt my soul.
The dance is actually not that. Even compared to other AOA dances, aside from that one where they like kind of like, these are our breasts, right? These are our breasts.
Look
like,
at that.
They don't actually do that much.
Here they are.
Boom. Yeah. And it's actually not even that bad.
It's not even that bad. It's not even that bad. It's just kind of funny, actually.
Yeah. It's actually a really cute moment in the dance one because they're like teaching the guy how to dance. It's like the Let's Dance.
Oh, like, whatever. Yeah, like, One Decade does, like, Let's
Dance. Yeah, One Decade does, like, a Let's Dance where they teach, yeah, like the Stig, right? They teach a dude in a helmet, yeah, how to do the dance. And so Sohyun was like, boop! And he was just like...
he was like, just show me one more time. but if I was that dude in the mask, I'd just be like, show me,
yeah,
one more time.
Yeah, show me, teach me again. But no, I meant,
slower,
like,
slower.
It's actually not even that bad. Like, there's more butt-shaking in Sistars. There's more, like... Sistar wore the tight, you know, the yoga pants of, like, yoga pants, mm-hmm, and their butts were, like, there was a part where Hyorin was, like, this is my ass, I'm shaking my, one of my legs, so my butt kind of collapsed. Like, it, weirdly enough, that didn't really have that much of this. But there was, like, the, hey, this one girl's boobs, did you know? Like, where she's, like, putting
you
on
know,
her.
You know, it was just, like, wearing a sports bra, where I was, like, just close it up.
But I, you know,
he needed new pants.
Yeah. Just close it up.
But at least for me, like, this is one of the few songs that I played a lot the last week. The other one being Selena Gomez. I really, really like that song.
I hate you because now I'm really into that song. I really like that song too.
If I could pick a non-K-pop song of the episode, it would definitely be Selena Gomez.
Song. God damn.
But
yeah, this music video didn't make shit ton of sense. They're playing lacrosse for one against the same team. It's boys versus girls. The girls aren't wearing helmets or uniforms.
Nope.
And Sohyun apparently is a part of the school already, but she gets introduced as
She was a transfer student.
But she was already at the game. What are you doing?
Oh, that's right. She was already watching from the sideline, right?
And it's like, okay, we have a new student, JK, but she's already part of our school. And she's apparently a super-duper cool lacrosse player, and she'll teach you how to do all the things
lacrosse
and how to be sexy and all that
and
stuff.
And win a game.
And then they win the lacrosse game.
And then Choa gets her man, I think. But even though he was eyeing Sohyun,
He was eyeing the shit out of us. Like, do you want a dude that's like eyeing the crap out of like another girl? I don't know if you want that.
No.
But you know what? At least they play the sport that they were dressed as. EXO, who were dressed as American football players, but they never play football.
Fair enough,
right? You got that going for you anyway. You played the sport that you dressed up in. Although,
is that what K-pop has come to?
You're playing the correct sport. Although everybody in the audience was wearing basketball
jerseys for some reason. I don't know.
Although I don't know if they make lacrosse, you know, jerseys. You know, you're not gonna. I don't play lacrosse. Is lacrosse a big thing in California?
Not really. No.
Really? I thought lacrosse would be pretty white there.
Well, that's rude. What about Wisconsin?
Wisconsin, you guys even play sports?
Hockey? They play hockey.
I mean,
it's
just football.
Rude. Hockey. Yeah, football.
I want to say that maybe lacrosse is a little bit more popular than in California.
It's kind of popular in Texas. I mean,
it's
in my
city.
So.
I wouldn't say.
I mean, Texas is all football. It's 90% football. Okay. So.
Yeah, like California, it's like basketball.
Maybe it's a Midwest thing.
Maybe. Anyways,
AOA, you can lacrosse me any day.
You can lacrosse me up any day.
Yeah. I made the mistake of watching. Remember, so you follow a lot of people on Instagram, right?
I do.
And I very purposefully don't follow K-pop stars on Instagram.
He says it desensitizes him. Because
it does desensitize me. Like, okay. When I, like, see so many pictures of Seohyung,
like
I'm like,
the sun.
He's
like staring
it's kind of like staring at the sun for too long.
Fair enough.
It makes you blind.
Okay.
I don't know. No, I really like, so like I try not to watch reality shows of K-pop stars because sometimes I feel
it
biases me. Like, I'm like, oh man, I'm going to like this song more just because they did it. But I, you know, I was bored at work and I was watching AOA's one of their TV shows or whatever.
Oh,
and
the
Fine Day, yeah, where they like go on vacation.
Oh.
And I'm like,
gotcha.
What?
Got him, coach. Got him, coach. Got him, coach.
The Mina girl, I did not know she was that pretty, but she pretty.
Dude.
Not this Mina girl. Sorry.
No, not this.
Oh!
All of AOA is gorgeous.
Just kidding.
Like, for real.
See ya.
See ya. Bye, Felicia. Bye, Felicia. No, we love you, Mina.
Let's move on. Let's move on. That's enough AOA.
We love you, Mina. But our next song is by 9MUSES with Hurt Locker.
Hurt Locker.
Hurt Locker. Do they know what that means, Hurt Locker?
I don't think they know. I actually Googled it. I it was a while ago because I was like, Hurt Locker? Like, what does Hurt Locker mean again? I've only know it from that
it's a
the
military
movie.
Term.
Yeah, it's like a military term for like a really, really bad
traumatic
like,
experience.
Yeah, experience. Yeah.
Or like, I thought it was like when they send, like if somebody dies like by an explosion or something and they have to send them in like a casket back.
Oh,
I thought
that
was that like
the
Hurt
Locker.
Hurt Locker.
I don't know. All I read
I'm not
was
sure.
That
I'm not
it was
really
for
sure,
like
actually.
A traumatic experience. You're kind of in the Hurt Locker. I thought like you just feel pain and suffering and you're sad. You know, kind
yeah.
of, which is not great for a summer song. But
yeah, like the Korean is dacha, and a dachaso means that you got hurt. Like you got like hit or something or
right.
cut.
Like they probably should have just called it Hurt, but maybe there's
yeah.
another song called Hurt. So we some guy was like, "I watched the movie last night.
It was called
Hurt Laka." So we should call it that. Let's start with Mina this time, because you love girl groups.
She loved them girl groups.
I love them so much.
Yeah. How about before this song, 9MUSES in general?
How do you feel about?
Yeah. How do you feel about 9MUSES?
I really didn't listen to 9MUSES.
You don't know.
I don't know much about them. Mm. I know that they're from Starship.
Are they from Starship?
From Starship?
No,
yeah.
They're not from Starship.
Then who's from
like
Starship?
Sistar? Starship?
Sistar from Starship?
Oh, no, not no Empire. Empire ship.
Empire ship?
Is that a real thing? Are
I
you just
know.
Yeah, it's the agency that houses Zaya.
That sounds plausible.
Okay.
Yeah, that sounds plausible. Empire something?
Empire ship.
It might be Empire ship, actually.
I don't
that
actually know.
That sounds a little bit familiar. I'm not too sure, but they're like a new company anyways.
Yeah. But, I don't really know.
Well, the thing was, I asked you that because I don't know a damn thing about 9MUSES. And you don't know a damn thing. Obviously,
one,
as we know.
I know one member of 9MUSES, Kyungri, because she's an attractive one. Sorry.
Know.
Your boy Josh is superficial, too. Sorry.
Alright, anyways, then what did you think about this song?
It went, oh!
I don't know, but, okay, so it's, I mean, it's not bad, but it's not, like, a song that I would download.
Okay.
I know you're gonna break my heart, but better or worse than AOA? The fact that there's an oh makes me sad.
Not much difference for you, right?
Yeah, there's not much difference.
Yeah.
Oh, that hurts.
So I can't really...
That hurts me. It hurts me.
Yeah, for me, okay, this song is not anything special, but I wouldn't call it bad. There's, like, two parts that are, I think, like, good components that if they had a chorus that was really, really catchy, this song would be really good. Like, the verse and, like, the build-up to the chorus,
mm-hmm.
they do a good job of, like, kind of taking it higher and higher and you're waiting and then the chorus comes in and it's kind of medium, you know?
Yeah.
And that's the problem for me with this song. It's really forgettable and...
Like, in a culture where the chorus is king, right?
Yeah, chorus is king.
Like,
yeah.
The chorus is so bland.
It is.
And, like, and even if it was at the same thing, like, it could have been blasted more, but it's, like...
It could be, like, higher register of noise.
Yeah, but the volume level kind of, like... It's like,
down a little bit.
It's like we're singing, and like they do a pretty good job of singing, and oh, it's building.
Medium.
Chorus.
It's like we're building up to high, medium.
Chorus, yeah. I will say there's a bad part. I think the rap is really bad.
I wanted to throw up a little bit.
Like I know... Bora's not a great rapper, but the smart thing with Bora's was they made gave her a cute dance, and they made it really, really short.
Yeah.
You know, I like Jimin's rap, actually. I think it matched in that song.
I think it did also match.
But this one was like...
We're like, what?
It was donkey balls to me.
Mama, no!
Like, I didn't think it flowed well at all. I didn't think it matched the song well at all. And it went on for twice to three times as long as it should have.
Too long.
Yeah, I don't know. Like, again, I was reading a lot of good things about this song. Like, this is the best summer song. Like, it's so awesome. And I'm like,
Mainly on K-pop Reddit.
Yeah, but I just was just like, well, I saw it on some comments too. And I'm just like, I don't understand, like,
why?
I mean, why? Like, what? Why was it like, I heard a lot of people like, it was so catchy. And I was like, oh man, like, I want to hear this song. I was actually really excited. And I was like, I don't know where the catchiness is, but I just can't see it. I just really couldn't see it.
Yeah, I'm with you on that. I'm not a big fan of the song. It's not very catchy at all.
And I didn't find it that summery either.
No.
But then there's the music video. And I also was reading some good things about the music video.
Mm-hmm.
And while it's kind of cool that they're doing this in like a shipyard, you know, like
a new change of scenery.
That's like kind of a cool change of scenery, right? They're on top of the shipyard.
We've never seen people do things in
shipyards. We haven't seen that except for I think there's a Tunisia video where she does her entire dance on a shipyard that I saw was like, they just copied this Tunisia video.
Mm-hmm.
It actually was kind of similar. I thought the video was very much a sorry, Mina, but it was very much a boy group video. It was just shots of their face.
Like, Mina's our representative
for all boy groups, right? Like,
she's the president of boy group bland.
It was just so bland. It was just like shots of their face, a little bit of dancing, sort of.
Shots of the tummy.
Shots of, yeah, like...
skimpy outfits.
They even were like, we got hot cars, guys. We got hot cars. We're going to stand near the hot cars.
This one's lime
hot
green.
Jeep.
This one's hot pink.
A
this
hot
one's
Jeep.
The Jeep.
Jeep is so
this
sexy.
This one's a Jeep Wrangler.
Yeah, like it's like Ferrari, right? It's like Lamborghini.
You
know, I don't
know. You know, like back in the 90s, there was kind of like this stereotype. It wasn't a good stereotype, but it's like whoever drove like a Jeep Wrangler or a Ford Mustang was either a woman or gay.
I got that a Ford Mustang was kind of weak. Or some dude who was really overcompensating.
Yeah, in California, that was like a stereotype that like went
not
around.
Not gay, though. I don't think it was ever gay.
Like gay people or women drove.
Mm.
Yeah.
I never got that for Jeep
Wranglers
Wrangler.
And Ford Mustangs.
I do know one of my friends in high school had a Jeep Wrangler. Like one without a frame. Like it was just a canopy.
Yeah.
And one day he was like, I just bought this sweet ass sound system. $1,000, which is a lot for high school.
Yeah.
And that day it was stolen because he doesn't have a fucking like door. You can't lock your door, yeah. Right? All you had to do is unzip the canopy and then just go in and take it. Yeah.
Wow.
So ever since then, to me, I'm like, who buys Jeep Wranglers? Only dumb people. And so that's why I think it's hilarious to me that like, compared to a Ferrari and compared to a Lamborghini or, like, a sick-ass motorcycle. It's, like, Jeep Wrangler.
At least throw in, like, a Land Rover or a Range Rover or a Jaguar.
Mm. Yeah, yeah.
But I think they were,
there's
like,
a lot of things.
We're out of cars. Jeep Wrangler.
For all we know, maybe in Korea, Jeep Wrangler is, like, a sign of super, like, yeah, rarity. Like Maserati? Nah. Jeep Wrangler.
Give me that Jeep Wrangler.
But yeah, like I thought the music video was so generic and
blech.
Boring. Like as much as I hate on or it's like lacrosse don't make no sense, like at least there was a little bit more to that. Yeah, I guess I'm sorry, 9MUSES. Like I think this was 9MUSES, like I don't know that much about 9MUSES, but for a long time, even though a lot of the other girl groups were going like super sexy, they were like you said, right, they were supposed to be models, right? They were always had kind of this sense of like not like we're gonna do things a little bit more high class. I thought
we're uppity.
Yeah, we're more like Sistar sexy, like Alone sexy, rather than you know AOA sexy, right?
Yeah,
or Girls Day sexy. That's what for some reason I remember 9MUSES as, and I thought this was their like we're
Sistar
gonna be like
sexy.
Every other girl group. We're gonna
we're
dress
AOA
in these
sexy.
Bright colors, and
we're
going
Girls
to
sexy.
Do
we're
sexy.
Sexy.
Yeah, and it just I just didn't think it worked at all. Like
it didn't.
I just really didn't.
Sucks. I mean, they're attractive girls. Don't get us wrong, but
I don't think that at all. I think the one girl's really attractive.
It didn't really do it for me.
Yeah. Well, speaking of girls that might have done it for you, let's talk about the next one. Mina, introduce this.
The next one is by a new group. Mm-hmm. Girl group. That this is their debut song. They are called Playback, and their song is called Playback.
Cool. What are you talking about? Yeah, it's like I don't trust the words coming out of my mouth.
He's like, did Steven write that correctly?
It's like, did he accidentally say playback? Playback?
Yeah, it's a self-titled song, Playback.
Right? Mm-hmm. Like, which people used to do all the time, of course, mm-hmm. back in the 90s, I guess. I don't know.
I guess so.
But they don't really do that anymore. Mm-hmm. Now, I don't actually know that much about Playback, but...
Neither do I.
Why don't you start first, because...
Me?
Yeah.
Okay, so when this song first came out, as Mina said, we have like a chatting room with me and Mina and Steven and another friend of ours, Anna. When this song came out, I was like, hey, yo, guys, you gotta check this song out. Like, you probably haven't heard of it, but I listened to the song and I thought it was really good. And Mina was just like, I heard that song.
No. It was, these girls are fucking hot. There was nothing about the song at first. The first thing was, these girls are hot, but they're probably 18.
No, that's a different group.
That was a different group.
Oh, my bad.
That was a different group.
I thought that was the Playback.
That's a new group, like Dia or something? Dia. Like Dia.
Did they have a song?
No, they haven't debuted yet.
Oh, then you were just looking at other pictures? Sorry, I actually kind of skip a lot of y'all's group chats.
Steve don't care.
A, I don't care. B, you spent like half a year talking in Korean, so I was like, I'm just going to skip all these messages.
That's not true. I don't start that.
That's true. She does.
But anyway.
Anyway, sorry, Playback.
The reason why I like this song so much, it kind of has like elements of different groups that I really, really like. And there's one or two girls in here that I swear they are like Korean American or something, because they have a very special kind of voice that I really, really like, and kind of reminds me of like a mini Ailey or like... you know, a mini someone who can really sing. And when I heard her voice for the first time, I was like, uh-huh, okay, yes, I like that. And I like that they kind of have, like, this style that I think is very kind of girl-on-the-street kind of attractive. Do you know what I mean, Steven? Like, it's not necessarily K-pop attractive, but...
Like, they're kind of wearing normally clothes.
Yeah, everyday girl kind of attractive, right?
Except for the fishnets.
I mean, most of the stuff that I see, right? Like, some of it is an exception, obviously, but...
Yeah.
Like,
it's a little midriffy, but yeah.
Yeah, I could see, like, girls wear this on the street, and I'm just like, okay. And this song kind of sounds like a 90s, like, girl group song to me. It reminds me of that one song you were talking about. What was that one song?
Wifey,
yeah. I really like that song as well, because that song kind of reminds me of a throwbacky song. And this song also reminds me of a throwbacky kind of song. But the bad thing I do have to say about this song, it kind of keeps like the same kind of melody in certain parts. They don't really do much with it, which is okay. But after a while, it kind of gets boring.
Yeah. No, I'd agree. Like, I think when I first heard it, for the first minute, I was like, am I kind of into this? But then the second minute was the same as the first minute. The third minute was the same as the first minute. I was just like, no.
Yeah, I heard it a lot already.
Like, it wasn't at, like, the variation that I kind of wish was there. The variation that I like and that I get in AOA.
Why are you guys gonna bring AOA back?
Because I need to defend it. I feel like I need to defend it.
We didn't really attack you like we thought we would.
The internet attacked AOA, and I'm angry for that.
I didn't attack
you. I said the internet. I said the internet.
Okay, I was like, how dare you say I said attacked the internet. AOA? I take offense. You know how much
my butt's been hurt.
Yeah.
Recently. Like, really, like, I know my tastes are not, like, the general taste, right? Yeah. It makes sense, because the general taste, they're mostly girls and mostly teenage girls,
true,
right?
Yeah.
But, like, you know, sometimes I just don't understand people, right? Like, I just don't understand when they're like, 9MUSES, that song is the best. I'm like, I don't understand you. So I've been feeling a little, like, insecure on what I like.
Yeah.
And, you know, knowing Mina doesn't like AOA at all, and Josh usually likes AOA, and he's just kind of like, man, on this, I'm just like, I kind of defend, like, I think this song is... Is better than...
I love AOA.
Sure.
I think that's why that song wasn't as great for me, because I was expecting so much.
I gotcha.
But Mina, what did you think about this song?
Playback? I really liked it. Right away when I heard so that one girl's
voice. I wasn't confused. Nothing. Keep going.
When I heard
the
that
same
one
girl, yeah. The first girl that's was the first or second girl that's
it's
sings.
The second girl.
Second girl
it was the second girl. I was like, hey, okay. And so but I also really like the 90s like girl
kind of
songs. Mm. So when I first heard it, I was like, oh hey. I like
hey,
this.
Yo, hey. Oh wait, sorry.
Okay.
That was an oh hey joke. That was an oh hey joke. You get me.
Yeah.
You get me? Alright, sorry.
AOA.
So I really liked it, and then I watched their
performance.
Mm-hmm. Well, what'd you feel about the performance? I haven't seen any of the performances.
Oh, it was like it wasn't bad. Like it wasn't like there wasn't like anything special, but it was like
they didn't like Mamamoo it.
Yeah.
But,
but
they're not bad.
But, yeah.
I do need to hear the song again, because the first time I heard it was today.
Okay.
So I kind of feel like, you know, maybe I like it a lot more.
This song came out, I think, also last week, and I've had enough time to listen to it, and I'm kind of sick of it already. Mm-hmm. It's like a reverse mushroom song. It was really good, and now it's because there's no variation in the mm-hmm. way they sing things. It's
kinda,
it seems very like cookie cutter. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Yeah,
I get you. All right, well, I think that's it for our main section. It was very, very long. So before we get to the lightning round, I want to thank our sponsor, Audible. So for being our chingus, Audible is offering a free audiobook download with a free 30-day trial to our awesome listeners. Now, if you have some free time, chores to do, a long commute, please give listening to audiobooks a chance after listening to the podcast, of course, by clicking on the link in the description or on YouTube and signing up for a free trial. If you sign up for that free trial, you are directly supporting us, and we want to thank you a lot. And to get an audiobook, right, you just go to audibletrial.com/TWIK. Again, that's audibletrial.com/TWIK for your free book.
Yeah.
A lot of great books.
If you guys are readers, and I hope you are because you should read, just take advantage of this. I mean, it's... You can basically read while you're doing something else.
Yeah,
right?
Yeah. And to be fair, I mean, you can get a free audiobook by going to audible.com regularly, but you can get a free audiobook and support us if you use the link.
Yeah.
So, like, even if you just want to try out their service, you sign up for the free trial, you just cancel before the 30 days are over, like, we still will get the support, if you know what I'm saying, for doing that. So you don't have to pay money to support us, right? You can do the free thing, and it still supports us. So please give it a shot. It really, really will help us do more things, which is what we want.
Yeah, if you guys I really, really like Josh and Steve, and I want to help them, in ways, but I just don't know how.
Yeah.
Well, iTunes reviews, for one. And two, clicking on these links that we provide. We aren't at the point where we're like, oh, we'll give you like some discount or whatever. These things you can do yourself, but if you use our links, we do get supported from that. So.
Yeah. We want to. One day we'll get big enough, I hope, that we can leverage that with advertisers and get you guys a better deal. We should email
Hidden Valley Ranch. Best ranch out there.
But yeah, so try if you want. I mean, if you can, support us by clicking on the Drama Fever link and the Audible link, and signing up for a free trial really will help us.
Mm-hmm.
Right, Mina?
Right.
Let's move on to the lightning round. Very quick lightning round. I guess I'll start with a duo, a collaboration by JuB from...
Dalshabet?
Sunny Hill, right? JuB from Sunny Hill and Yuk Ji Dam from I'm Pretty Rap Star or Show Me the Money with their song My Sympathy. Now, for the longest time, right? If you're a long time listener, as we like to say, I love and Josh loves when there's a singer and a rapper.
Yeah.
Now, usually it's girl singer, male rapper. Usually. Yeah. But this is girl singer and girl rapper. And still, I really like the song.
Me too.
I really like the song.
I really like the song also. What do you think about it, Mina?
I forgot how it went.
I mean, it was the one where she was...
The guitar one?
Yeah, she was playing guitar. Oh. She was working in the cafe, and it was Yuk Ji Dam who was wearing too much makeup.
That one.
Yeah. I think that's the one you like better. Yeah. Because, I mean, at least I thought so, because your head was kind of bobbing.
Yeah. I like this one better than
the second one. Yeah. Like, Yuk Ji Dam, I mean, if you watch Pretty Rap Star, I mean, like...
it's not bad.
Did you watch Pretty Rap Star?
Yeah, a little bit.
Like, I kind of never really liked Yuk Ji Dam's kind of, like, flow or her songs.
Not bad, not good.
Yeah, but I thought... because she had one song with... Like, she had the very first song, actually, with Zico... the one produced by Zico that like nobody really really liked, but she was like, I'm hard as fuck and I'm going in hard, and I was like, I don't want that, so I was afraid when it was like JuB and Yuk Ji Dam, and then the JuB part started and I was like, oh man, she sings really nice.
I love
like,
Sunny
Hill. I was like, oh my god, is Yuk Ji Dam come out and be like, brah, brah, you know, I'm like, oh Jesus.
bitch, better have my money.
Oh my gosh. But she didn't, like, I thought she matched decently well with the song, and it's definitely a song that I'm going to download because I really like these kinds of songs.
Yeah, I recommend it. It is kind of like, I don't want to say cliche, but it is very similar to kind of rapper or singer songs. But me and Steven really like these songs. And if you are in that same kind of mindset, then please check the song out. I doubt very many people have listened to it or know about it. But JuB and Yuk Ji Dam, My Sympathy.
Next.
You want to introduce the
next
song?
Next is Tymee featuring Subin. Love Is.
Love is the moment. It's not that song, sadly. Tymee also from Pretty Rap Star.
And Subin from Dasha Bet.
Yeah, Subin from Dasha Bet. Another one where it's like, oh my gosh, girl singer girl rapper, let's do this.
Subin, great, great, great singing. Subin does really, really, like, interesting things with her words and kind of, like, her syllables. And, like, it just really, really, really fits the song. Hmm. But the rapping, not so great.
I just didn't think it matched very well.
Yeah. What did you think, Mina?
I don't like it.
I just straight up.
I should have just.
Okay, what about the singing?
I like the singing.
Okay.
But the rapping part, I was just like, really?
Yeah. And it was proportioned. It was proportioned different. Like, I think the JuB Yuk Ji Dam one was like, the JuB sang for quite a long time.
Yeah.
And Yuk Ji Dam had like a kind of shorter part, but this one was like
half rap.
Subin is like, it's a tiny part for the chorus, and then it's a really long, tiny part. And it's like,
okay, less Tymee, more Subin.
Yeah. So, but you know, maybe you might like it. Like,
yeah,
you know,
check the song out as
well. I didn't think it was like the worst song I ever heard in my life.
But Subin definitely is the part of the song that's the best.
I've definitely downloaded songs in my life where the chorus like carries the shit out of the song.
Yeah.
And I don't know if I download this one, but you know, you never know.
I might. Yeah, I might. I have to listen to it again.
Yeah.
Yeah, but our last song of our very long podcast is our Chingu Verbal Jint featuring Sanchez and Bumkey with Doin' It.
Doin' it well.
No, that's not the song.
That's not the song.
But this song is hilarious. This song is about Verbal Jint and a girl. She doesn't like hip hop. She doesn't like anything that the Korean title is Shirte, which means like she says she hates it.
Yeah, basically. She hates everything.
So Verbal Jint just raps about this girl who hates everything, and she only likes him because of the nasty.
Yeah. And the chorus is in English, so you definitely will fully understand what he meant.
When we're doing it.
Yeah.
And of course, sung by the amazing, amazing Sanchez.
Cheesy.
And he definitely, like, you know, there was a point in my life where when I heard Verbal Jint is a Verbal Jint song, I'm like, yeah, let's do this. But recently, like, his rapping parts have been
kind of not my thing.
Yeah.
So
not my thing. And I don't think this changes that. Like, if without Sanchez in this song, like, it would just be an instant, like, turn it off, you know, turn it off, you know?
And I feel like you really didn't really need Bumkey. Bumkey comes in at, like, this weird part of the song. Yeah. And you're just like, whoa, Bumkey, what are you doing here? Yeah. Sanchez could have sung this part. Like, yeah. You don't
really and probably that. Better and silkier.
Silky. God
damn, I mean, Sanchez. I think Bumkey, like, he's like, I'm innocent! And he's just like,
I'm doing music
Let
now.
Me do all the songs I can possibly do now. Maybe that's it.
Yeah.
Maybe he's doing it.
doing it.
But, like, it was weird to me because it was like, because this is a, you know, this is a doing it song, right? And, like, Sunny had a song, right? Body Language, which is about doing it. But, like, that was such a better song, like, in as a whole, right?
Let's
And, I mean, of course, you know, Jay Park always likes to sit doing it, right?
Sex Trip, right?
I'm not talking about Moment. Moment is a different type of song. That's a fun song, though. That's a really fun song.
I like this song.
But, like, you know, Sex Trip had his, like... So this is, like, a like the Verbal Jint version of that song. And it's kind of a boring kind of version of it.
It's a Verbal Jint version.
Yeah, it's a very verbal, like... He's like, yeah, I like doing it. I'm Verbal Jint.
Da shit.
Yeah. So if you like... If you want some of that Dirty Sanchez, please check out
the Dirty Doin' Sanchez. It.
You likes it when we doing it. Man, we doing it
in the butt.
That's not what he says.
That's not what he says.
But it is Dirty Sanchez.
Yeah. All right. Well, I think that's it for episode 73. It's a very long one.
2 hours plus.
Yeah, it'll probably be 2.5 hours after I edit in the songs. I want to thank, of course, Mina.
Thank you for coming, Mina.
Waking up at least.
I don't know how you're gonna sleep tonight.
Yeah, I don't know how that's gonna work tonight. You know, I'm sure we're going to have you back sooner, you know, sooner rather than later.
Mm-hmm.
I do want to mention though that next week we will have an episode. But the week after that, or the episode after that, we're both going to be in America.
Yeah.
So I just want to warn you guys to expect an episode in 2 weeks, but there probably will be a month break, after that because we'll both be in America.
Yeah.
So we just want to warn you early and, this was a big ass week.
A lot of good songs.
A lot, yeah.
Yeah. I mean, there was one definitely good song.
All right.
Okay, so.
Yeah, that Yuk Ji Dam song.
See you guys. Bye.
Yeah.
Maurice.